significant improvements. MAPS is working to legalize MDMA research by 2021. A controversial national park in Tanzania has been the subject of protest by the Uvinji community. The small coastal fishing community is comprised of only 130 people, but their cause has received international attention after their land was included in a new map for a game reserve. The Tanzania National Parks Authority is attempting to drive the community out of the reserve, which now includes their land. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Marjorie Wildcraft's Grow Your Own Groceries. Homegrown food on every table. That's growyourowngroceries.org. Support also comes from Be the Media, a workshop, mini-conference, and party exploring alternative media and celebrating the launch of the Liberty Beat GCN partnership. It happens Saturday, October 25th, and will be live streamed at thelibertybeat.com. Be the media and change the world. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, October 16th, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. And make sure you like us on Facebook. That's facebook.com/thelibertybeat. 1 year in the House of Correction suspended on good behavior for 1 year and 100 hours of community service. That's the sentence handed down Thursday to the host of the nationally syndicated Free Talk Live radio program. Ian Freeman's sentence was decided by Keene, New Hampshire Superior Court Judge Edward Burke, arising from the charges of unsworn falsification and prohibition. The charges stem from an arrest in April of this year and were based on the state's claim that Freeman failed to file the proper paperwork in order to use the name Ian Freeman for his New Hampshire driver's license. Freeman's given birth name is Bernard. Freeman's show co-host of 12 years, Mark Edge, provided character testimony, telling the court that Freeman would not learn from being locked in a cage and has, through Edge's influence, recently toned down his controversial civil disobedience activism. Freeman told the Liberty Beat he's thankful that he's not going to jail and that a suspended 1-year jail sentence is a hefty price to pay for getting a name change. The state prosecutor had recommended a sentence of 60 days in jail. The Free Barrett Brown Organization is asking supporters of the jailed journalist to mail letters to the judge that will sentence him on November 24th. The organization is asking for sympathetic letters detailing Barrett's contributions to be mailed to Judge Lindsay. Barrett Brown has been behind bars for 2 years, a portion of which was spent bound by a gag order. He was originally accused of sharing a hyperlink to stolen data, hiding laptops, and federal agent. Support for Liberty comes from Midas Resource Incorporated, helping us convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to lead gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-227. That's 800-686-227. Support also comes from Sovereign Living, a podcast, blog, and reality show about what it takes to live a voluntary and natural life. Check the blog at sovereignliving.com and watch episode 1 of the soon-to-be-released reality sovereignliving.tv. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, October 17th, 2024. Ryan Hagen reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
This is the Onion Week in Review. Allentown, Pennsylvania, 5-year-old Trisha Billings announced from her dining room Saturday that the circle was no longer her favorite shape. The landmark declaration comes just days after the 5-year-old changed her favorite color from red to purple. While experts have struggled to determine what Billings' interim favorite shape will be, the 5-year-old assured reporters that the majority of her favorite things will remain consistent for the time being. Disney executives revealed in an interview Friday that all of the company's animated and live-action movies take place in a single, unified universe, saying Never Never Land is actually mere minutes away from the jungle where Timon, Pumbaa, and Simba danced in a straight line and sang Hakuna Matata. Company heads stated that every character from Air Bud to Jiminy Cricket all inhabit the same interconnected world, just as Walt Disney envisioned it.
A lot of people don't know this, but Daryl Hannah's character in Splash actually lives in the exact same coral reef where Nemo went missing, and if filmmakers so desired, they could have Princess Jasmine, for example, hop into Herbie Fully Loaded to go watch the Jonas Brothers 3D concert experience.
This is Free Talk Live. Dial in toll free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you tonight, it's Ian here.
And Daryl.
All right, join us online over at freetalklive.com. You can get interactive there. The various features there are completely free, unlike those other talk show hosts in the business, most of them who will charge you for their websites. There is one who will not. He is Michael W. Dean from the Freedom Fiends. He's in the same camp as Free Talk Live. You do the freebie website giveaways just like we do, Michael Dean. Welcome back.
I pay people to look at our website practically.
That's even better. So welcome, sir. What's on your mind tonight?
How do I sound? I'm using a new piece of radio kit.
You know, you sound okay.
Sounds like you have one of the best microphones for podcasting.
You sound good. Go ahead. What's on your mind?
Mark wanted me to call in and ask about this. He's not there, but you can answer this as well as he can, I'm sure. The Freedom Fiends just got added to another nighttime station, and it's WSRQ in Sarasota.
Congratulations.
Thanks. So we're the weirdos on in the middle of the night there when people can't sleep. And I wanted to know if that was the first station you were on and want to know a little bit about the history of Free Talk Live and radio in general for Liberty.
Yeah. No, it is not the first station we were on. WSRQ is the third station that Free Talk Live was ever on in Sarasota, Florida. We started on a different FM talk station that no longer exists. And they booted. That was back when we were with Clear Channel, which is now known as iHeartMedia. Clear Channel back then, they flipped their format over back to a music station eventually. But that was after they had already blown me out the door and taken Free Talk Live to a brokered AM station in town. And that means we were paying for airtime. And then at WSRQ, we were not paying for the airtime there. So we were back on sort of based on merit. And it is that at that station where we began in our world of syndication with Genesis Communications Network. And then I moved the show from WSRQ to my own home studio because at the time WSRQ, this is no longer the case, but WSRQ was run by a drunken old man who was basically essentially a danger to his own operation. He would the studios at the time were in downtown Sarasota, and they were right out on not
and
quite.
This is a dozen years ago that you're talking about.
This is about 10 years ago. About 10 years ago. Totally new management there at WSRQ. It's a very professional operation now. Mark and I actually went down there a couple years ago and did about a week's worth of shows from their Sarasota studios, which are very nice. Totally different crew. But this old guy that used to run the station, own/run the station, I wouldn't say he totally ran it into the ground, but he pretty much did. His management style included, they were on Main Street. They had some really sweet, like Main Street location kind of studios with, you know, kind of the window front to Main Street in Sarasota. I mean, really a nice studio, nice location. And it happened to be three doors down from the Gator Club, which is a bar. And so when the Gator Club would open up, when they would open up at, you know, 11 in the morning or whatever time they would open, he would leave his office and go down to the Gator Club and proceed to start drinking, come back to the office later on in the afternoon, you know, three sheets to the wind, and start making management decisions. So wasn't really the optimal situation to work in, and I certainly didn't want to have Free Talk Live sort of being at the whims of this drunken manager. Because, you know, I didn't want him to be able to just decide, oh, I don't want him on the air anymore, so see you later. So as soon as we started with syndication at WSRQ, I began the process of planning and building our own studio. So that way, we would be completely insulated from any drunken whims of the manager. There you go. That's my WSRQ history.
It's pretty bizarre and inspirational to me that you have built the ability for true Liberty Radio to exist, and there's not a lot of it. We're the other syndicated show that's on, you know, 33 stations, and there's a couple shows here and there, I think, that have you know, three. I think the Wandering Capitalist, what's that guy's name, the guy that, the expat guy.
Ooh,
I think
I
he's
know.
On three stations from Vietnam. There's a few of them.
I know
there,
John Bush,
you guys paved just the way for it. I mean, now what was it like when you were a Harry Brown Libertarian Party small government guy, right? And you were trying to sell this idea to stations. What was on the stations back then? Was it Rush? Was it Hannity? Was it the same usual suspects as now?
Yeah, I mean, for the most part, the second or third tier shows tend to change out here and there. The lower, lesser known names in the business, kind of like Free Talk Live.
So yeah, but for the most part, the big players were kind of still the same.
Did people, did program directors you were talking to even know what you meant by liberty? Like now, if I call a station and say, yeah, we're a libertarian show, they can at least say, I don't like that and I know what that is. But back then, did they even know what that is?
I don't, well, you know, the ones who are libertarian would understand the code, I guess you could say, but we wouldn't really sell the show as a libertarian show necessarily. Just sort of selling it as a show that is going to be something that, you know, all your listeners could can appreciate to some extent, or that, you know, we're not Republican, we're not Democrat, and neither are most of your listeners. There was the Talkers magazine does this survey of talk radio listeners every year, and they ask them, you know, well, what's your political leanings? And most of them, like 60% of them, are not identifying with Republicans or Democrats. So we were positioning the show in that way as a show that could be heard on both of those kind of, you know, lefty or righty stations. I still position the show that way.
Yeah, I don't. I say libertarian generally, but maybe that's a mistake.
No, I don't think think that it is. I mean, the only reason I don't like using the term libertarian is because I don't want to.
Oh, you mean like Glenn Beck?
Yeah, well, Glenn Beck's more probably libertarian now than he ever was, but like Dennis Miller or Neil Bortz, two particularly warmongering self-proclaimed libertarians.
Well, and the funny thing about Neil Bortz is Neil Bortz actually used to be a legitimate libertarian.
Was he ever anti-war?
Back in the Clinton
during the
days,
Clinton years, okay, yeah. So
when the Democrats were going to war,
yeah. Yeah, and then, you know, when Bush came in office, he became a warmonger.
Yeah. No, I remember Neil Bortz. He's a talk, for those that don't know, he's a talk show host out of Atlanta who had a syndicated show mostly in the Southeast for a long time.
He was actually my introduction to libertarianism.
He was one of the earlier voices I'd heard, and he's right on a number of issues. I mean, he's good on the war on drugs, for instance. He's good on education. But not so good on not being in favor of war.
I think he still promotes the fair tax.
Oh, yeah. Didn't he write a book about that or something?
He did. He literally wrote the book about the fair tax.
That was awful. So, yeah, she had one of those fair tax guys on the show many years ago and just tore him up. Really just ripped him up. So, Michael Dean, congratulations, man. 33 radio stations in how many years now of syndication? Two? Coming up on two?
Oh, about 15 months. We came
not
we
even
got
a year.
On
Dude,
last
not even
year
years.
On May. Yeah.
Okay. That's pretty awesome, yep. Man. That's it took me a year to get five. So,
well, you we're standing on the shoulders of giants. I can say, a lot of the stations you guys are on. So we're like, yeah, we're kind of like Free Talk Live, but we have a bunch of co-hosts more than they do, and we don't take calls. So that's easier than explaining it from the ground up.
That's a good point. Yeah.
Yeah, and I think we're on like four stations. You're not, but yeah, most of the stations we're on, you're on.
Cool, man. So what else did you want to hear? Any other historical questions?
I'd like to hear more about adversity that you faced early on that you don't face so much now because you've built that.
What kind of adversity?
I don't know. I just maybe talk radio program directors being like, I don't know what that is, or putting you on and being like, I don't like that.
Okay, so
that still happens occasionally.
Yeah. Most talk show, I mean, Daryl's been doing a lot of calls recently to stations, and when you connect with somebody for the first time, a lot of times they still won't know who the hell you are. I mean, they don't read the industry trades close enough, or they're not paying attention to the advertising or whatever. I mean, we've been out here for a decade doing syndicated talk radio, and Most of the program directors still haven't heard of us. You still have to connect directly with that person in order to have them be aware of you. But, you know, when you're in the early days, the biggest issue that you have to get over when you're trying to sell a show to radio stations is that they don't know who the hell you are, and why should they take your show when they've already got 24 hours a day of programming, especially when all these new shows that come up tend to go away 6 months to 2 years later. So why should they go through any effort to change their schedule if you're not going to be around? So being able to stick around for a while and stay in the same place with the same syndicator, I think, was a real big key. Michael Dean, thanks for the call tonight. Michael Dean from the Freedom Fiends, freedomfiends.com. We're coming up here. You take control. Free Talk Live. Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw-free enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states, it's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Americans are reeling from Obamacare, higher prices, and an epidemic of policy lapses. AsiaRunLikeHellGuide.com has you covered. World-class medical and surgery at one of Asia's most modern hospitals. 300 doctors, surgeons, and dentists serving 300,000 patients a year. Fractions of U.S. prices. Friends or family forced to go out of pocket? Avoid bankruptcy. Tell them to run. Run like hell. Hit us up now. We'll show you how. AsiaRunLikeHellGuide.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
This is Free Talk Live. We'll take your calls here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. Still haven't really talked about what happened at the Supreme Court on Wednesday. With the Robin Hood case, and Daryl, you are here, and you happen to be at the Supreme Court.
Yes.
So you were live tweeting, as a matter of fact, from there. We can talk further about that and play one of the news reports about the Robin Hood Supreme Court case. Don't know what that is? We'll tell you more about it coming up here in a moment. Also, in other court-related news, I got a few different court stories here tonight. There was a news story that we were talking about a few days ago here on Free Talk Live that was pretty disturbing out of Houston, where there's a few disturbing things going on. One, the city earlier in the year in May, city council passed a anti-discrimination ordinance that basically makes it so you can't discriminate in a business that is open to the public on a variety of different measures, whether it's, you know, somebody where they're from or their gender or whatever.
So why is this disturbing to you? I think I know why, but a lot of people, they might hear, you know, like, it's disturbing that you can't discriminate.
Yeah.
And automatically they're going to start thinking the worst things about you.
That's
so why
yeah.
is this disturbing to you?
Well, because I think that people should be free to discriminate because I want to know who the bad actors are in society. I want to know who the racist business owners are, for instance, so I can not patronize their businesses. And I never really understood why somebody wouldn't want to know this about the this information about somebody who their employer might happen to be. Why would you want to work for somebody who doesn't like you? You know, they don't like you because you're gay, or they don't like you because of your skin color or where
right.
you were born. So I feel like if a business owner wants to hire people or fire people based on those ridiculous
or turn away customers.
Or turn away customers, exactly. I want to know about that. And I want them to advertise it publicly. I want them to, you know, just like Christian businesses, sometimes you'll see them advertising that they are Christian because
right.
they feel like that's going to help them. Well, if these guys feel like it's going to somehow benefit their business to be out in the open about their bigotry, then I think they should be able to do that. And
right.
especially in the information age we find ourselves in, it's not a difficult thing to learn information like this about bad business owners. So why not make it legal? Why not allow people to do that? I guess Houston apparently did not ever have any kind of anti-discrimination ordinance. They were sort of relying on whatever federal protections would be out there. But now they've taken the federal protections and they've gone beyond that to the point of, you know, even more restrictions.
Yeah, you know, that way if somebody does something wrong, they can be charged with, you know, two or three offenses for the same thing because there's the city, the state, and the federal offense.
Yeah, so they passed this Houston something ordinance.
The
acronym is HERO is what it is. And the mayor was apparently subpoenaing certain pastors in the city demanding through court order that they hand over sermons that had to do with gender identity and homosexuality and the mayor herself. The story from WashingtonTimes.com, subpoena prompted a storm of criticism when it became public on Tuesday. The pastors are involved in legal efforts to overturn, here it is, the Houston Equal Rights Ordinance, also known as the Bathroom Bill, because the most controversial part, I guess, about this is that businesses are not allowed to discriminate on who can go into what bathroom now as a result of this.
Okay, so here's an idea. Why not just have unisex bathrooms?
Well, that's what they're doing. They're
like,
legislating
No,
that.
Like one stall, and then, you know, don't put anything up as far as, you know, like man, woman,
sure,
stick
but
figure,
if you've already
whatever.
Got, but if you've already got bathrooms with more than one stall, then what are you going to do then, right? You're
right.
not going to be able to part those off to where you have eight bathrooms or something like that. That's just not going to happen. The way those bathrooms are designed, that's just not possible. So larger businesses that are designed to accommodate more than one person in the bathroom at a time, they're apparently going to have to allow anybody into those bathrooms that wants to go in there. Now, look, I'm progressive on this issue. I think it's a fine idea to have mixed-sex bathrooms. I think that, you know, people need to get over the issues that they have there. But I also, at the same time, understand why some people feel uncomfortable about that. It's
right.
It's a new thing for society, sort of like women walking topless is a new thing for the American society. And
although it's been common in Europe for decades.
Sure. Again, I think it's totally fine. I think that people should be able to walk naked if that's what they want to do. I think you're risking your nether regions to the elements by doing that. I don't think it's necessarily the smartest thing to do, but I think you should be able to do
perfectly
that.
Legal in Vermont.
In most places in Vermont. Some of the cities in Vermont will outlaw that, as I understand it. Brattleboro, for instance, does have a city ordinance, or did. Maybe they got rid of it.
I think the ordinance in Brattleboro is only on disrobing in public.
Oh, so you can just be in, walk into the city limits and be naked?
Nude in public. You just can't become nude in public.
Does that mean you can disrobe in private and then walk into public? So if I walk into a bathroom with my clothes on and then, like Superman, disrobe, come out of the bathroom, or walk into a phone booth or something?
That's
like that?
My understanding.
Yeah.
And I'll look
okay.
this up to make sure that I'm, you know, not.
Is that because disrobing
something.
Is sexy and nudity is just nudity?
No, because you can disrobe as like a performance art
yeah.
sort of thing.
Hmm. Well, I mean, but what I mean by that is that nudity on its own is not necessarily sexual. Maybe the suggestion is that disrobing, the act of disrobing,
right,
could be considered sexual, like a strip tease or something like that. So back to the story here. This bill resulted in a lawsuit. So certain people who were being affected by this or didn't like it, they tried to gather signatures to get the bill canceled or to override it or something like that. The signatures were disqualified, so a lawsuit was filed. And then in response to that lawsuit, these subpoenas were issued by the city of Houston. The pastors and their allies called the city's broad demand a threat to religious freedom and proof that gay and transgender rights bills can be used as weapons to demonize Christianity. Some Texas Republican, Ted Cruz, says the government has no business asking pastors to turn over their sermons. Ms. Parker's office initially doubled down in the face of the criticism, but issued a statement late Wednesday saying the mayor, quote, agrees with those who are concerned about the city's legal department's subpoenas for pastors' sermons. The statement continues to say that the city will, quote, move to narrow the scope during an upcoming court hearing, and that attorney David Feldman for the city says the focus should be only on communications related to the petitions to overturn the ordinance. So what they want, what they're claiming they only really wanted, they didn't really want the sermons about homosexuality that they originally demanded. Now they're saying what they only want is communications that these pastors had with each other and anyone else about their petitions to overturn the ordinance. I guess they're trying to uncover some sort of intention to fake the petitions. Because they had to collect 17,000 petition signatures, and they collected 50,000,
right,
but then almost all of them were disqualified.
What's happened in a lot of places is that, you know, petition signatures are public record. So what happens is if something that some people find, you know, not popular, they will then go get the information of all of the people that have signed and then just post it of, hey, here's all of the people that signed to do X.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a way to sort of shame them publicly and to ridicule them. So it could be that that's why they're trying to get the information on the gathering of the petitions. I don't really know.
That doesn't make much sense to me. I mean, these people already publicly signed the petition. The issue was that a bunch of them were thrown out. I think they're trying to find some sort of conspiracy to fake the petitions. I think
could
that's
be
what they're trying to do. 855, 450 free. But anyway, the mayor's office says they're backing down on their demand. So that's a little bit of good news. More coming up.
Question. Could too many GMO foods and toxins be overloading your digestive and immune systems? Answer, yes. If you're searching for a powerful detox that's gentle enough to use every day, use Pro-EM-1 from Terriganix. Pro-EM-1 is a powerful liquid probiotic that uses good bacteria to suppress pathogens and gently eliminate toxins from your body. A healthy digestive system will cleanse and remove toxins, support weight loss, improve absorption of food nutrients, and aid in controlling yeast and other infections. Pro-EM-1 is made with only non-GMO and certified organic ingredients, has no preservatives, and is dairy, soy, wheat, and gluten-free. Pro-EM-1 is the key to your digestive health. Order Pro-EM-1 Daily Probiotic Cleanse at Terriganix.com, spelled Terriganix.com. Or call toll-free 866-369-3678. That's 866-369-3678. Also available through Amazon Prime. Pro-EM-1 from Terriganix. Life's getting better.
Hey guys, Mark Claire here, LionsOfLiberty.com, where we strive to advance the ideas of liberty daily. We bring you The Morning Roar! That's right, every Monday to Friday, we'll have a brand new edition of The Morning Roar, where we provide a roundup of some news stories that you may not find in the mainstream media, or even in your typical social media news feed. We find stories that relate to the ideas of liberty, and provide you with our liberty perspective on them. Every Monday, we have our longest-running feature, Mondays with Murray, named after the great libertarian Murray Rothbard, where we'll examine an article or an excerpt from his works and help convey his view, along with our little spin as well. We wrap it all up every Friday with Felony Friday, where our own John Odermatt goes out and takes a look at some sort of felony. There's felonies committed every day, you know, whether it's a felony committed by the police, a politician, or even an average citizen. You can find all of this and so much more over at LionsOfLiberty.com. Advancing the ideas of liberty daily.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll-free here. Our number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online and go to freetalklive.com. All the features there are completely free. So once again, that is freetalklive.com and ExpressCoin's best choice for you to get your cryptocurrencies. Not just Bitcoins. They've got Bitcoins, of course. Litecoin, Blackcoin, Darkcoin, Dogecoin, all available through ExpressCoin.com. They are a licensed money services business, so they've jumped through those annoying federal hoops to make it easier for you to get your hands on Bitcoin. Of course, you can't actually touch the Bitcoin because they're digital. But you can buy them with money order, check, wire transfer, and you can make a deposit at a local credit union that has shared branching. Get started right now at ExpressCoin.com. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, ExpressCoin.com can help you. And you can even do it from your smartphone by downloading their app, available also at ExpressCoin.com. Plus, you can buy up to $40 worth of your favorite cryptocurrency with no fee, no transfer fee, if you use coupon code FTL. That's FTL like Free Talk Live. ExpressCoin.com, coupon code FTL for the sweet deal. Now, even if you buy more than $40 worth, you'll still get a great deal. It's a 3% transfer fee on more than $40 worth, which is the best price I think you're going to find on the internet. So check it out, ExpressCoin.com. So we got a little bit of good news. Not the court in Houston, it's the public pressure that is resulting in the Houston city government that had issued subpoenas to local pastors demanding they turn over copies of their sermons to see if those sermons had any sort of anti-homosexual preaching or whatever. Now, look, I like gay people. I just want to make it clear. I don't agree with the sermons or whatever they might possibly say, whatever hate speech that these supposed Christian pastors are engaging in. I certainly don't agree with the hate speech, but I also don't agree with forcing them to turn over their sermons from their church. I think that's outrageous.
Right, and it's not just Christians that could be gone after. It could be, Muslims, Jewish rabbis, Buddhists, any religion that has a teaching against certain sexual activities could potentially be gone after. In this case, It appears as though they were only going after the supposed Christian pastors.
They were only going after what appeared to be a handful of them as well. So it wasn't as though they were demanding that all of the pastors in Houston turn this information over. Just the ones who were actively involved in the petitioning process, I think, to try to overturn this anti-discrimination ordinance. So I don't feel like there's anybody who's really lovable in this particular story, right?
Right.
You've got the mayor and her cronies who are attacking these pastors for trying to just simply work within the political system, and then you've got the pastors who are probably despicable, you know, in their own way because
right.
they hate people because of their sexual orientation. So I don't much care for any of them, but I will stand on the side of free speech. You know, and the government's
right.
the government here is attacking free speech, and when they were called on it publicly, they did publicly back down from this. They haven't yet filed the motion in the court to lessen the restrictions on these subpoenas, so it hasn't happened yet, but they claim that that's what they are going to do.
And let me correct something that I had said in the last segment, where I said that I thought that it was legal in Brattleboro to be nude as long as you did not disrobe in public.
Brattleboro, Vermont.
It was actually in 2007 when their ordinance got passed to make it illegal to be nude in public, with some exceptions, such as in a hospital or in a public shower. So obviously, you know, like, you can be naked in a public shower, and also art classes.
Where do you have public showers?
Gyms.
Yeah, but those are private showers. Maybe a public shower would be at a beach or something like that.
Swimming pool. But even the ones at the gym are technically
those
considered.
Are private.
But
it's open to the public.
The gym is open to the public.
Okay. Okay.
And a lot of times they'll just have a large shower. They don't have individual showers.
But the word public has different
It also says
meanings.
And or private.
And
at
or.
The beginning
okay.
of the exemptions.
Got it.
But, you know, an art museum, for example, is open to the public.
Right.
It might be privately owned, but, you know.
I think that's an important distinction to make, and it's usually not made in sort of pop culture news releases and things like that.
No, things open to the public is what I meant
okay.
when I said public.
So, yeah, that's Brattleboro, Vermont. So what we were talking about before is that Vermont, it's legal generally
yes.
to be naked. In public, but there are some exceptions, like some of the cities there.
Yes.
And apparently, despite all that nakedness that could be going on in Vermont, society has not crumbled there.
Right.
People are still okay. The children are relatively well-adjusted in Vermont.
Yeah. Vermont also has better gun laws
than New Hampshire.
And actually, most of the country.
Yeah, Vermont and Alaska are two of the best.
And Arizona.
Arizona. They recently became better, right?
About 6-7 years ago,
yeah,
maybe.
That's fairly recent on the scale of government time.
Yes.
So, yeah, I would love to see that happen in New Hampshire. In fact, I was talking with a couple of the guys from court security today, and we were talking about gun laws and things like that. Anyway, let's go to, so we got Skype here. James is on the line in Arizona. James, you're on Free Talk Live.
Yes.
Yes.
Minister.
You are on the radio, and you're
well,
a little bit overmodulated.
Minister.
Maybe back off the mic a little bit.
Minister, I don't want my 17-year-old daughter sharing a bathroom with a creepy 30-something-year-old man, let alone having her have a right to walk around nude. But I know that's not just me, but hundreds of millions of your fellow Americans that feel that way.
Well, I feel like people who do own private businesses should be able to set whatever rules they want to. So obviously I don't support forcing businesses to have multi-sex bathrooms.
Forcing? I'm not for government forcing businesses to do that either.
I didn't say you were.
I'm talking about common sense and decency. That's what I'm talking about. But anyway, you found it so fascinating, North Korea. Last Friday, you were talking a lot about it. I just wove goodbye to my neighbor, who's an elderly Christian gentleman, who was one of a million-strong, warmongering member of the U.S. Army. That is the difference between North Korea and South Korea to this very second, just as the warmongers that my dad was that lived in Western Europe in the early 40s is the difference between that and the Ruskies overrunning Western Europe after they overran the Germans. So you think that
South Korea would be a part of Korea and part of North Korea today were it not for the United States?
If it weren't for the United States military and a million-strong army that over 30,000 of them didn't come home in the early 50s, I'm not just saying it's a fact, if you knew your history. So I was just calling in to defend the warmonger that is Dennis Miller, who is pretty libertarian. And there is no such thing as being anti-war as the equivalent of being libertarian. In fact, I consider it to be the exact opposite.
Oh, well, no, no, no. You could always fund warmongering around the world, I suppose, no, and on your own and be a libertarian, I guess.
Minister,
I'm sorry, your call is ducking out while I'm talking, so I can't hear a word you're saying, but thanks for the call tonight. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Now, generally, libertarian, the kind of the classic definition is, at least from the Libertarian Party, I remember when I started with the Libertarian movement back when I was around 20, I signed the agreement with the Libertarian Party that said I don't support or advocate the initiation of force to achieve political or social goals.
That's the libertarian pledge.
So therefore, you could still be libertarian, I think, and support people who are defending themselves around the world, right? So if there was some sort of a fight between people of some country, you know, let's say a civil war, for instance, and you felt like there was one side that was under attack, you could then send them money to defend themselves, or you could go and join up with their military or join up as a mercenary or something
like that. Right, because defensive force is not the initiation of force.
And you'd still be a libertarian. But as far as the United States government is concerned and all of their warmongering efforts, then you know there's not defensive violence going on there because the government has to initiate violence against people in order to fund. Even if it were doing defensive violence for something, they are initiating violence in order to fund that defensive violence, and so therefore I can't be in favor of it as a libertarian. I can't be a libertarian and be in favor of a military that's funded by the threat of force. More coming up.
Hey guys, if you're into fantasy football, you've got to check out FanDuel.com. At FanDuel, you play in one-week fantasy football leagues for real money with immediate cash payouts. You only play when you want, and you can change your team any week. FanDuel is paying out over $10 million every week this season. And right now, FanDuel is giving you up to $200 free. That's right, for every dollar you deposit, FanDuel will match it up to $200. Just go to FanDuel.com, click the microphone in the upper right corner, and enter code FOOTBALL70. FANDUEL.com, code FOOTBALL, the number 70.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
The experts at Web.com want to build your business a successful website for free, just like we did for these current Web.com customers.
We've used and looked at other website designers, but there's nobody better than Web.com.
Web.com can build your website in as little as 7 days free. Plus, we'll promote it on all the major search engines like Google, Yahoo, and Bing. If after 30 days you're happy, we'll continue to provide promotion, hosting, support, and maintenance, all for one low monthly fee. If not, cancel and pay nothing.
If you're in business today and you don't have a web presence, you won't be taken seriously.
Call right now and you'll also get a free .com or .net domain name for your new website powered by VeriSign, the world's leading domain name provider.
Call 800-297-0154. That's 800-297-0154.
No upfront charge for site build, after which ongoing fees apply. Rights to site are relinquished when canceled. Domain included during active service, after which fees apply.
That's 800-297-0154.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration.
and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Kay Oliver is part of the Tweyambe Women's Group in Jinja, Uganda. She gets old clothes, fixes them up, washes them, and then sells them at the Jinja market. She was quite happy with her success at her business, but realized that a sewing machine would really help her make more money to take care of her two kids. Free Talk Live helped her get that sewing machine. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound, try out the subscription, cancel at any time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online. Go to freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that we share with you. Once again, that is freetalklive.com. And if you support Free Talk Live, you can go shop with us at shop.freetalklive.com. There are links to Amazon there. Click into the right Amazon for you. There's Amazon Canada, Amazon UK, and Amazon US. You click in the right one for you, get your shopping done. Free Talk Live gets a cut of the sale when you do that. It's very simple. It helps us out a lot, and you get the same great deals and the same Amazon experience that you're used to just entering through our affiliate links at shop.freetalklive.com. So more court-related news. We had the Robin Hood Supreme Court hearing today.
It was on Wednesday.
The days all blend together for me. It was Wednesday. You're right about that. And so we had it on Wednesday. It actually has been in the works since December, basically, because it was back in December of 2013 when the Robin Hood case was thrown out of the Superior Court on a motion to dismiss. Now, what is the Robin Hood case? Who are the Robin Hooders? Daryl, how would you describe the Robin Hooders? What is Robin Hooding?
Let me define Robin Hooding first.
Yeah.
Robin Hooding in the term here is people in Keene, could be anywhere else, but people in Keene, New Hampshire, who go around town with the purpose, first and foremost, of putting money in parking meters to prevent the parking enforcer from writing parking tickets.
Mm-hmm.
And in late December of 2012, Robin Hooding changed from just, you know, somebody randomly once or twice a week or once or twice a month, you know, just whenever they felt like it, going downtown and walking around and putting some money in meters for a couple of hours, to be basically a focused activity that was taking place all day, every day.
That's right.
Monday through Saturday. Whenever there was a parking enforcer out, there was at least one Robin Hooder out.
Yeah, it was pretty epic.
And it also changed to try to walk as close to the parking enforcer as possible. Because before James Cleveland sort of started funding... Well, no, and let me explain why. And when I say as close to... It'll make sense in a second. When I went out and did some Robin Hooding in December of 2012 for some community service, I went out and just walked up and down Main Street, and every meter that I saw that had a car at it that was expired, I put a couple of nickels in. Wasn't necessarily near the parking enforcer.
Yeah.
So James said, try to be near the parking enforcer, preferably in front of, that way you can catch the meters before the parking enforcer gets to it.
That's the classic method, in my opinion, is to walk in front of the parking enforcer and save people from getting tickets. In fact, the card that the Robin Hooders put on the windshield says, Your meter was expired, but you know, we saved you from the king's tariff.
Right, and there was no card before like January of 2013.
Not true. Well, there was no card, but there was an envelope.
There were envelopes that had a handwritten letter.
Correct.
And the business card was printed up basically upon commission by James Cleveland.
So I think it's dishonest to leave a business card that says you save somebody from a ticket when you don't know if you save them from a ticket. Like
I wasn't putting things on people's vehicles. I was just in meters.
Some people were, because after some locals started to push back on this, there were some local thugs that were threatening the Robin Hooders in the streets, for instance. Some of the Robin Hooders decided they were no longer going to be in the vicinity of the parking enforcer, and therefore they were then placing cards on people's windshields when they hadn't necessarily saved them. They would fill an empty meter,
right?
So that was happening, but they weren't doing it necessarily in front of the parking enforcer. So who knows whether or not that was, you know, that was an actual save,
right? That's so when I went out, I was just, you know, putting money in meters that had been expired.
That's a nice thing to do for somebody, but it ultimately doesn't accomplish any outreach, because, you know, when you're leaving a card or an envelope or something like that, then the person can learn what happened. They'll, you know, have some explanation as to what was going on. Otherwise, it's just that they all of a sudden found some extra time on their meter rather than a ticket. So, you know, I have a different viewpoint on how to do Robin Hooding than some of the people in Robin Hooding today. But regardless of all that, the city of Keene came after us with a lawsuit. They were demanding the creation of a zone, essentially a floating 50-foot radius zone that would surround the parking enforcers. They would walk about the streets. They ended up coming down on that from 15 to 30 to ultimately 15 feet over time, trying to come down just to make it more likely, I guess, that they would get the injunction against us. They never did.
They also kept claiming that there was a civil conspiracy.
That's right, yes.
Which I'm still not entirely sure what that means.
I don't know, but it sounds bad, doesn't
But they basically, the evidence that they had, or the allegation that they had to support the civil conspiracy, was they had two-way radios.
So they went to the Supreme Court this week, since the lower court kicked it out. And here's WMUR's report from the event.
This group, known as the Robin Hooders, simply say they're filling parking meters and exercising their First Amendment rights. But others say their actions are intimidating and abusive.
Bum, bum, bum.
Madam Chief Justice, may it please the court, my name is John Meyer. I represent five of the six.
Mr. Meyer, if I did this to you, you would be alarmed and offended.
Tough questions right from the start for the lawyer representing the Keene Robin Hooders, a group of activists who follow parking enforcement officers and videotape them on the job. Keene City officials had accused them of harassing and verbally abusing the meter workers, describing them as in the meter readers' faces.
Which, of course, is a ridiculous exaggeration, and that I don't think that's ever happened, that a Robin Hooder has gotten up in the face of one of the Keene parking enforcement officers. Never have I seen that happen.
Maybe incidentally, such as some of the incidental contact to where two people were reaching for one of the flyers at the same time, and they touched hands, or the parking enforcer backed into somebody when they were trying to put a coin in a
meter. Neither of those things would I consider to be in someone's face, however.
Right, but those were both incidental contacts that were being reported by the city as assault.
Well,
so what
that's
I'm
ridiculous.
Saying by, you know, incidentally being in someone's face is somebody stops walking suddenly and you take an extra step before stopping.
Right.
You might get within 2 feet of them.
Even then, in order for you to be in their face, they would have had to have been walking backwards if you were following them or something like that.
Right.
It's an odd phrase. In your face to me means getting 6 inches or 12 inches away from someone's face and like shouting or talking to them or something like that.
It is an odd phrase, but I could see it happening incidentally. I wouldn't go as far as to say that it never happened.
I've never seen it happen. That's what I said. And I've, you know, been on the streets often enough to interact with these people. I personally have never done it. But yeah, I mean, if you're in close proximity to someone for hours every single day, as the Robin Hooders were, it's inevitable eventually that you're going to come into closer proximity simply
right.
because, as you said, it's an incidental thing. Like they come up to a crosswalk. They're waiting to
right.
cross across some traffic, and then you catch up to them, or they catch up to you either way. You know,
right.
That kind of thing. So, you know, no, it is not behavior of a Robin Hooder to put a camera in someone's face or to get in someone's face, because that's pretty rude. And I would understand why someone would get upset about that. But, you know, the city people here are just essentially lying about what happened because they want to make the Robin Hooders look bad.
City asked the lower court to get them to back off.
Your Honor, the peace of mind of the public of PEOs, the parking enforcement officers, is not a compelling interest. It does not justify restrictions upon First Amendment rights.
So true. So true. Even if people were shouting at these bureaucrats in downtown Keene, it would be legal for them to do that. You know, whether or not it would be legal to get within 12 inches of the person and invade their personal space, I don't know what the laws are about that. I certainly wouldn't recommend that behavior. But as far as like being rude to them and being nasty to them, that's completely legal. And in many cities, this job would be much more difficult for the people in the parking enforcement positions. Like Keene is nothing compared to what you might experience
New York City,
parking,
Philly, San Antonio,
DC.
Birmingham, Alabama, Atlanta,
right.
Georgia.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. So, yeah, I mean, look, Robin Hooders aren't behaving that way. That's not the way that I've ever seen a Robin Hooder behave towards the people in the city. I've always seen them being nice to them, even though what some would argue that I did recently was not nice. Where one of the parking enforcement agents wanted me to leave them alone. Well, I'm sorry. It's my job to continue being nearby you when you're ticketing people or attempting to ticket people. And just because you want me to go away doesn't mean I have to honor that request because you work for the government. And that makes you different from the average worker. 855 450 free, but people don't understand that. More coming up here on Free Talk Live.
Hi, Chuck Woolery here. I don't know about you, but I don't like taking pills for minor arthritis pain, and I don't like those patches either. But I have found something that works, Australian Dream Arthritis Pain Relief Cream. It's a great product. It doesn't smell or burn, isn't greasy, and it works. And Australian Dream has an empty jar guarantee. You can use the whole jar, and if you're not happy, you get your money back. But I doubt you'll send it back. This stuff really works. Australian Dream is now available at Target or your favorite retail store.
Nothing compares to a good cup of coffee. But if you're getting your coffee from the store, you're likely not getting a good cup of coffee. Free Talk Live's teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you a free pound of the best coffee, shade-grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is that for every 10 people that get coffee through our link, coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. When the loan's paid, we lend the money again. Help others, one cup at a time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of your taxes funding endless occupations around the world? Antiwar.com is run by people who understand that wars abroad become wars at home, wars on our freedoms. Antiwar.com is dedicated to bringing you the latest in news, views, interviews, and reviews from the top movers and shakers in the anti-occupation movement. Antiwar.com has it all, from thorough foreign policy analysis to interviews with whistleblowers who used to run the military-industrial complex. Antiwar, pro-free market. That's Antiwar.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, October 17th, 2014. Silver is trading at $17.38 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,240 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $385.
Antiwar.com reports, a month into the Islamic State push against the Kurdish border town of Kobani, the Kurdish forces in the city are continuing to hold it and have even made some progress. Commanders of Kurdish forces say they've driven out the Islamic State from parts of the town, and they believe they can take back the pockets of resistance of the Islamic State fighters elsewhere. Exactly what's going on the ground remains unclear, as Kurdish factions are keen to manage the narrative. People across the border in Turkey, however, reported considerable fighting is still visibly going on in the city. Though, when the battle for Kobani was going poorly, the U.S. insisted that it was not a priority. The Obama administration has launched scores of airstrikes in and around Kobani, and if the Kurds manage to expel the Islamic State, even temporarily, expect U.S. officials to change their tune and tout it as a vindication of their war strategy. The Islamic State has tried to take Kobani several times, unsuccessfully, and has significant reinforcements incoming. Needless to say, the battle for the town remains far from resolved. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They now take Bitcoin for purchasing precious metals so you can turn your profits into a long-term investment. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing. 800-874-9760. The Associated Press reports FBI Director James Comey warned in stark terms Thursday against the push by tech companies to encrypt smartphone data and operating systems, arguing that murder cases could be stalled, suspects could walk free, and justice could be thwarted by a locked phone or an encrypted hard drive. Privacy advocates and technology experts called the concerns exaggerated and little more than recycled arguments the government has raised against encryption since the early 1990s. Likening encrypted data to a safe that cannot be cracked or a closet door that won't open, Comey said the move by tech companies to protect users' communication in the name of privacy is certain to impede a wide range of criminal investigations. Comey said new legislation to allow law enforcement to intercept communications is needed at a time of advancing technology and new forms of communication. He said in a Brookings Institute speech, "We have the legal authority to intercept and access communications from information pursuant to court order, but we often lack the technical ability to do so." Comey cited particular cases in which he said access to cell phone data aided in criminal investigation, but in a question and answer session after the speech, he said he could not cite particular instances in which someone was rescued from danger who would not have been had law enforcement been blocked from the information. The speech, which echoes concerns he and others in law enforcement have previously made, comes soon after announcements by Apple and Google that their new operating systems will be encrypted or protected with coding by default. Law enforcement officials could still intercept conversations but might not be able to access call data, contacts, photos, or email stored on the phone. You can support FPP Radio by shopping online. Whether you're looking for t-shirts, precious metals, bitcoins, or books, you'll find that and more at shop.fppradio.com. Every purchase you make from one of my affiliates at shop.fppradio.com helps fund FPP Radio. That's shop.fppradio.com. Reuters reports a U.S. federal court has dismissed a $200 million civil lawsuit filed by a family of a man being treated for schizophrenia who was shot 23 times by police in West Virginia, drawing criticism from the local chapter of a national civil rights group. U.S. District Court Judge Gina Groh of the Northern District of West Virginia ruled that the use of deadly force by five officers in the city of Martinsburg was reasonable and justified in the March 14, 2013 shooting death of Wayne Arnold Jones. Police said Jones, who was taking medication for schizophrenia, was first struck with stun guns after he became angry and refused to follow orders. He then pulled a knife and stabbed one of the officers, causing minor wounds. Police said that led to the shooting. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
From Betty Davis's first role as a piece of chocolate cake in the 1931 film Palmy Days to the discovery of Niagara Falls in 1996, The Onion looks back at this week in history. On May 16th, 1929, the first Academy Awards were handed out in categories such as Greatest Achievement in Blackface, Best Catholic Whipping Scene, and Most Gorgeous Gams on Abroad. The highlight of the night occurred when Wings won the award for Best Picture without a single Dago, Tar Baby, or Wetback. And on May 15th, 1940, the first McDonald's opened in San Bernardino, California, back when a young Grimace was just working as a cashier. And that was what happened this week in history. As Martin Luther King Jr. once said, history is actually pretty racist.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll free. 855-450-FREE is the number. That's 855-450-3733 with you tonight. Ian here.
And Daryl.
Hey, don't forget, you can join us online over at freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that are waiting for you there. Once again, that's freetalklive.com. For those of you just tuning in, we are giving you a bit of a recap on what happened in court the other day. On Wednesday, the Robin Hood case coming to the New Hampshire Supreme Court. Maybe it'll end up in the United States Supreme Court eventually. The city of Keene seems willing to appeal. So we'll see what transpires. Will the court rule in the favor of the Robin Hooders? Well, the Robin Hooders are people who are known internationally now for saving people from getting parking tickets. That's what most people think about Robin Hooders, that we're good people doing good things. But there's a smaller segment of people who hates the Robin Hooders. They think that we're evil people who are just mean and nasty, and that we're being rude and threatening and intimidating towards the parking enforcement, a.k.a. meter maids, here in Keene, New Hampshire. Even one of the meter maids, the male of the original three, now two remaining, the male meter maid quit his job, ostensibly because of health conditions that were being brought on because of the stress of having to deal with us horrible, horrible activists. So that's kind of the position of the city, is that we're threatening and intimidating and harassing their employees, and they brought a lawsuit against us to try to stop us from doing this. Of course, it's also a factor that, oh, I don't know, we probably saved $80,000 from being put into the coffers of the city, and that $80,000 stayed in the individual pockets of the motorists from whom we're prevented getting a ticket.
And that 80,000 figure, as far as I know, that's just a guesstimate, right?
That's probably a low-end guesstimate would be my guesstimate, because we know we went through around 8,000, at least 8,000 cards, and that was not quite by the end of 2013. I had asked James Cleveland, a.k.a. Robin Hood, about how many cards had been gone through, because that's sort of an indicator of how many of them, how many vehicles had been saved. You wouldn't generally leave a card somewhere if you hadn't saved a vehicle. And so at least 8,000 of them, I think, was a solid number.
Okay, and parking tickets are $5. With late fees, the city actually winds up getting about an average of $10 per parking ticket issued?
Correct. If you look at the total number of tickets issued every year, and you look at the total revenue, and you do the division, it comes out to about $10 per ticket. So 8,000 times 10, $80,000 saved. That's the way we look at it. That's the way I look at it, at least.
And then something else, and this, of course, is going to be the unseen of knowing that there are days when the parking enforcers just quit early because Robin Hooders are out. So then there's, hours during a week where there is no enforcement. So that's an additional amount of people that were saved.
That's a good point.
In theory,
an unquantifiable number of people.
And then,
like during Keenevention, for instance.
Right.
When,
so during Keenevention, the city has already admitted that they've reduced the hours of the parking enforcers. They've not reduced the hours that the meters are, supposedly being checked, which is from 8 in the morning until 6 at night.
Yeah.
So they've not reduced those hours, but the number of hours that a parking enforcer is actually out, they've reduced. So there's another unquantifiable number of people being saved because there's just nobody out trying to enforce the meters.
Yeah, that's true. And then every time one of the activists like you, Daryl, has taken a parking ticket to court, that pulls one of the parking enforcers off of the streets for at least an hour. So I remember during one of my trials, because I've taken a few of these to court as well, and I went to Concord, actually. There was a $10, you get $10 tickets in Concord, New Hampshire. And in that particular case, they, of course, waited through all of the other arraignments and things like that in the morning. And
right, because they don't want people seeing somebody take a parking ticket to trial.
Exactly. And so there was a full courtroom full of people, and they waited through all of these hearings. So the whole time we're in there, so's the parking enforcer. And when finally the parking enforcer gets up on the stand, they're under oath. So I asked this lady or guy or whoever it was, I asked the person, I think it was a lady, kind of a manly looking lady. Anyway, I asked her, are you on the clock right now? Because sometimes police get bonus time for coming in and doing trials. So I wanted to see if she was getting paid overtime just to be there for the trial, or if she was just on the clock as a regular parking enforcing agent at that time. And she admitted she was in fact on the clock at that moment. So I said, well, would you normally be out on the streets right now giving out parking tickets, you know, doing your normal duties? And she admitted that she would normally be out on the street. So it had been 2 hours in court prior to beginning the trial. The trial itself took another 45 minutes to an hour. So ultimately, I kept this lady off the streets from 8 in the morning until 11 o'clock. And she said, you know, she would have written at least 20 tickets by this time in the day.
And in Concord, the parking enforcer, was that the person that was also prosecuting the case? Or
no.
Was there a prosecutor?
They had a prosecutor.
I'm surprised the prosecutor didn't object to any of your questions.
Why? It's a fair question, because normally when the prosecutor asks questions, they in the beginning of introducing
right.
some bureaucrat,
the reason that I say that is because when I've tried some of those questions here in Keene, the prosecutor objected.
Really?
And Judge Burke sustained the objection.
Wow, I don't recall that
it's
happening.
Irrelevant. Doesn't matter how much the parking enforcer gets paid. Doesn't matter if they would be out writing tickets right now if they weren't in court.
Okay. Well, yeah, you never know who, you know, how good the attorney is in any given case. And in this case, I feel like it's completely legitimate questioning, because typically...
Oh, I think it is, too.
Well, let me explain why. You may already know why, but our listener may not know. So when you go to a trial... they call some government bureaucrat up to testify against you, police officer, or in this case, a parking enforcer. Usually the first five questions that they get asked are generic questions about who they are and what their job is and what their responsibilities are of their job. So if those are the questions that are being asked on an initial questioning, then cross-examination is completely legitimate to ask more questions about their job. I mean, maybe giving their paycheck amount, would I could see that being objected to, but to object to what they would normally be doing, what would your normal activity be if you weren't in court right now? I feel like that's a completely legitimate question.
Yeah.
I don't recall that happening, but you were there, obviously, so you would. So the Robin Hood case, let's continue with the WMUR report. They had one of their cameras there. There were actually three cameras present for this particular trial. I was grateful that they didn't force us all to pool coverage, which they certainly could have done.
I think there were actually four people filming.
That's true. Garrett Ian was in the
Garrett
back.
Garrett had a camera, and he was, you know, just randomly switching who he was pointing it at. And apparently that's the video that got posted on Free Keen. And somebody...
What?
There's one of the videos from the Robin Hood case that was posted on Free Keen on Thursday.
I posted the full raw trial video from my camera.
Okay, well, somebody from Cheshire TV had mentioned to me on Thursday about the video that was up there just randomly, like all of a sudden shifting from who it was looking at and weird jump cuts and something.
They weren't watching my video. I mean, I definitely...
And it sounded like Garrett's style of video where he'll just like randomly zoom in on something and then... change swiftly.
Weird. I don't know about that. I mean, maybe they just didn't like my style of recording. I mean, I definitely panned. You know, I would pan the justices and I would zoom in on the justice that was talking. I don't feel like that's unusual.
Yeah. I don't know. The way it was described was just like random zooms on weird things.
Hmm. Okay. Well, you know, there's no accounting for taste. You know, everybody's got their different style. So we're going to continue here with some more of the Robin Hooding from Supreme Court. A little bit more of the clip from the WMUR camera person that was there. We'll share the rest of that with you, which includes a little bit of the interview they did with me outside of the courthouse. And then, Daryl, get your impressions on how the trial went, because I thought your observations were very pertinent and interesting. We'll come back with that. Your calls and thoughts are welcome. Obviously, the decision has yet to be rendered. It could be another year, you know, or more before that happens. Or maybe the end of the year. Maybe tomorrow. You never really know with these people. More coming up. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And then more court-related news, and this is not good news. Parents may be liable for what their kids post on Facebook, according to one court decision. We'll give you more information about that. It's terrible. More on the way. It's Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE.
If Americans continue their reckless disregard of the U.S. Constitution, our freedoms and way of life may not continue. Original Intent, Spoiler, and Moulin Labe is a three-movie special that explains what we can do. From the director of Fiat Empire, this trio of movies features Ron Paul, Pat Buchanan, Edwin Vieira, and many others. On sale now at moviepubs.net. This is a mini library you don't want to be without.
Gabino lives in Palcapata, Peru. He buys old appliances like irons, radios, and TV sets, fixes them up, and resells them. He saw an opportunity to expand his business and needed a loan to buy more appliances. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan, and the expansion was a success. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
Hi, I'm Derek J. I don't want a politician to represent me. To me, government is the idea that one group of people can coerce everyone to comply with an edict or face increasing punishments up to and including death. Despite perhaps the most noble of intentions, the best government services are a far cry from what could be provided for by voluntary interactions. Besides, the people who call themselves the government wage wars and put peaceful people in jail for crimes involving no victims. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll-free here and bring up whatever you want. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you can join us online. Just go to freetalklive.com and get interactive there. Is privacy dead? Well, not if you have anything to say about it. On November 7th and 8th, coders, privacy specialists, and idea people of all stripes will join together for Hack the Trackers, a transparency and privacy hackathon brought to you by Ghostery. You can enter online or join them in person in New York City to create tools that make the web a more transparent place or help users manage how much data they share. The hacks will be judged by experts and voted on by an online community. Winners will receive a prize package, including the all-new Black Phone, a secure-by-design smartphone for people who recognize a need for privacy and want a simple, secure place to start. Participation is free and registration is open now. Visit hackthetrackers.com for more information. That's hackthetrackers.com. As we continue, hear more on the Robinhood Supreme Court hearing that happened this week in our very own New Hampshire. Concord Supreme is where the location of the Supreme Court is. We've been there a couple times in the past, and things were relatively uneventful in the antechamber, if you will, the outside areas of the court. Last time I was there, I was threatened with arrest for chalking outside. I didn't arrive within enough time to do any chalking, really, this time. We got there and pretty much had to go in and get set up. But then the time previous to that, there was a very rude man in the court security call. We took lovingly call him Dennis the Menace. His name was Dennis. And he took to shouting and screaming in the ear. You want to talk about getting in someone's face. This Dennis the Menace character, the court security officer, was yelling at Kate, one of the Robin Hooders, a couple years ago at the Supreme Court. And was very intimidating and very harassing and very threatening towards her, literally shouting at her from less than 12 inches away from her. It was absolutely ridiculous, and that video was posted to freekeen.com. But nothing like that happened during the Robin Hood hearings.
Right, right. And it's funny that you had mentioned shouting 12 inches away, because one of the justices kept asking John Meyer the question, would it be okay to shout 12 inches away from somebody and just shout lullabies? And the question was first asked to the city's attorney of, would we be here today hearing this case if these people were shouting lullabies? Because that's completely neutral speech.
Mm.
You know, so you're not saying, like, you're doing a great job.
Right.
You're not saying, quit your job. You know, lullabies like, hush, little baby, don't say a word. Daddy's going to buy you a mockingbird. You know, like, that's neutral speech as far as how it goes. And the city's attorney was like, stammering, and I forget exactly how he answered.
Yeah.
But then when John Meyer was up presenting the case for the Robin Hooders, the question was asked of, you know, like, could I follow your clients absent a law? And they made sure that they kept saying absent a law or ordinance. Could I follow your clients 12 inches away and shout lullabies at them? And the reason that I think the judge kept saying absent a law or ordinance is there's already a law in New Hampshire against stalking.
That's correct.
Which would apply to a private person.
Right.
Would not necessarily apply to a government employee on the clock in the performance of their duties.
So you think it would be legal for someone to enter into the personal space of another person like that who was a government employee?
I think based on the current wording of the law, it would be
Couldn't
legal.
Couldn't that be considered a threat?
It could be. It depends on, you know... It depends on context.
Couldn't that put them in fear for their life or something like that?
It would definitely depend on context.
Yeah.
It would also depend on, is it for 2 seconds? Is it for 2 hours? So, you know, it's one of those things of context really means a lot when determining whether or not someone violated something.
So let me continue here with a WMUR piece. We are going to just play the remaining minute here. It's only a two-minute piece from WMUR out of Manchester, New Hampshire, covering the Robin Hood Supreme Court case.
with the Robin Hooders that their actions were protected speech. But the city took their argument to the state's highest court Wednesday, hoping to create some type of buffer zone.
What we're asking for is to please step back out of the face. Give us some breathing space. So,
this guy is such a scumbag.
Right.
Please step back out of the face. Give us some breathing space. He makes it sound like Robin Hooder's job is to get in people's faces and constantly be in their face.
Right. And
when they're trying to write
the
tickets.
The zone that he's asking for, the 15-foot zone.
Mm-hmm.
I could not count the number of people that were within 15 feet of me when I was sitting in the courtroom.
Yes.
Because, you know, there's another chair 6 inches away or less from where my chair is. So, you know, if I wasn't sitting against the wall on the left side of me, there would have been at least 2 people within 3 feet of me.
Well, but were they parking enforcers?
No, they weren't, but... You know, what he's saying is if you're less than 15 feet from somebody, then you are potentially harassing and all of these other things.
He's not saying that.
Not exactly.
He's suggesting that the Robin Hooders are getting in people's faces constantly.
Right, but he's also in a roundabout way suggesting that anyone that's within 15 feet of another person
true
is
it could create a
potentially
like
harassing and all of these other things.
Yeah.
And then when we were standing outside after the hearing, you know, a bunch of people standing outside, people getting interviewed by the media.
That's right.
I think there were 50 people within a 15-foot radius of me.
Sure.
So would all of those people wind up, if the Supreme Court winds up, you know, giving the city what they want, then would they wind up saying that nobody can be within a 15-foot radius of another person lest the person feel that they are being harassed, intimidated, or any of these other things?
I don't know if they can make a decision like that. I have to say, I don't know for sure, but I don't know if that's one of the questions.
Based on the wording of current laws, I don't think that the Supreme Court of New Hampshire could rule in favor of the city. That's why the Superior Court threw it out.
Okay, so one of the theories about the attorney here, the city attorney, who, by the way, is not the attorney for the city, they're hired guns, private
yes.
attorneys. It's basically what they do, though, is they represent municipalities in court, so they're making big money off of cities all across New Hampshire. Anyway, the theory, one of the conspiracies, is that the city of Keene doesn't want to win and that the attorney's job is essentially to throw the case and fail, like that he doesn't want to win this case. He's glad that he lost at the Superior Court because now he can appeal to the Supreme Court. He can cash a big paycheck when all's said and done. In fact, he gave Carla Garrick, the president of the Free State Project, a full-on hug outside of the courthouse after this event. And Derek J. apparently caught that on video. I've yet to see the footage, but from what I understand, that was completely caught on video. So this guy's making big bank off of this. The taxpayers are the ones footing the bill for it.
Right.
And ultimately, the reason why, the theory is why they want to fail is because if they succeed, then they can be subject to employee termination suits or whatever, some kind of employee rights suit. And so if they are, you know, if basically the decision of the Supreme Court is, well, you know, it's not the city's job to protect you from what people have to say to you, then there is no basis for a suit on the behalf of the employees. More coming up here on Free Talk Live.
With autumn in the air, it's time to think about getting ready for winter. And it's time to save at herbalhealer.com. You'll find amazing seasonal savings to prepare you for the fight against cold and flu season. Like oregacillin to promote lung health. 30 capsules, regularly $34.95, now only $25. HHA olive leaf, a natural antiviral, normally $16.95, now 60 capsules are just $12. HHA elderberry power, a great flu and virus fighter, regularly $16.95, 60 capsules, now $10. Save on all our homeopathic detoxes. Choose from lungs, kidney, liver, brain, libido, or whole body, normally $26.95, now just $20. Visit herbalhealer.com and click on the fall-winter specials button to save on all our natural cold and flu fighting products. Also, explore our Herbal Healer Academy correspondence courses that teach you how to handle your health naturally. HerbalHealer.com, healing the world with nature, one person at a time, since 1988.
Keenvention is coming up October 31st through November 2nd. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, attend social events like the costume party. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, James Robin Hood Cleveland, Rich Paul, and Free State Project President Carla Garrick will be keynoting. And we'll have all kinds of panels, including the new Cop Block panel and the new Movers panel hosted by the outlaw Josie Wales. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark at freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
There is no such thing as attention span, according to Jerry Seinfeld, who figures that people have an infinite attention span if you are entertaining them. Hey, he's kept us from channel surfing for several decades, and now he's making more millions as a Las Vegas headliner. With money and attention so scarce now, effective communication skills have never been more important, especially if you're looking for work. So choose every single word as though it was the last word the person you're speaking to will hear. Otherwise, it might be. Avoid redundancies such as added bonus, advance warning, end result, prior history, or personal belongings. And avoid cliches like the plague. Just kidding. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. We invite you to take control of the airwaves here toll-free, 855-450-FREE. We've also got Skype. You can Skype into the show at username lrn.fm. Now, if you care about your online privacy, you need to know about ProXPN. You go to proxpn.com/FTL. Download their software for free to get started. Doesn't matter what operating system you're on, Windows, Macintosh, Linux, iOS, Android. Linux users, by the way, setup's a little bit different for you, but the other systems is really easy. Linux is pretty easy. Of course, Linux, you know, things are always a little bit more difficult with Linux. It's just the way it is. proxpn.com/FTL. Use promo code FTL50 and you'll save 50% off the price of the annual account. Now, the annual account's always the best price anyway because you're buying annually, but you're going to save 50% off of that price by using code FTL50, and that brings the price down to around $5 a month, which is amazing, but it can get even cheaper. When you pay with Bitcoin, you'll save 62% off the price of the annual account by using code FTLBTC. Now, what is the ProXPN? It's a virtual private network, and it's global. They encrypt your data, meaning that you're protected from having your internet service provider snooping on you, which is probably what they're currently doing to you. So go ahead and upgrade to the premium account whenever you're ready at proxpn.com/FTL. With the premium account, you get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world you can access, you can privately torrent, and get past regionally blocked websites. Plus, ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits at all. You get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. Don't forget these codes, FTL50 or FTLBTC. It's available for you over at proxpn.com/FTL. It's a great discount on privacy that is priceless. More from WMUR's coverage of Robinhood at the New Hampshire Supreme Court. A good chunk of the Robinhooders were in the courtroom that day, as well as a lot of supporters. I was really pleased with how many people came out. Even people who have jobs to go to during the daytime came out to support the Robinhooders. It was the biggest turnout I've seen yet at a Supreme Court hearing. I've only been to three Supreme Court
hearings.
It's
one of the larger turnouts that I've seen for any court hearing.
Yeah, it wasn't near the size of like Pete Nademo in Greenfield when they were being charged with wiretapping the cop block founders.
That was before I got up to New Hampshire.
Right. So I've seen a few more that were like literally packed. There were still some open seats in the Supreme Court.
Right, but it was still, I said one of the larger. Yeah. I didn't say the largest.
And are you counting the people you didn't know? Because there were a lot of people in there who I did not recognize. You know, people.
There were
in
a bunch
suits.
Of people I didn't know.
Yeah, people in suits, that kind of thing. So it was great, though. Lots of activists came out from different parts of New Hampshire to support the Robinhooders. And there's full video coverage of this. Maybe, you know, maybe you don't like my camera style, but it's up there over at freekeen.com. In fact, I linked to it in this report about what WMUR put out there about this, which was, you know, 2 minutes of what was ultimately a half hour long session. You know, as far as court videos go, Supreme Court's hearings are actually fairly interesting to watch.
Yes.
You know, it does require a little bit more of, you have to pay attention because you're listening to legal people talking to one another.
Right. And rule one of appearing in the New Hampshire Supreme Court is assume that the judges already know the facts and the details of the case.
That's correct. They've purportedly done their research. And it's their job to essentially needle these attorneys. And the judges, they're fairly good at it, it seems. They've got practice, and they try to appear as though they're unbiased. They try to ask tough questions of both of the sides.
And I think the reason that they ask the really tough questions is to try to figure out the slippery slope of, if we rule in your favor, then we would then have to allow this, and then have to allow this, mm-hmm. and then ultimately we might have to allow somebody to walk 12 inches behind a government employee shouting lullabies at them.
So let me play the remainder of this. It's only about 40 seconds left. This is from WMUR.
Arresting is not the way to go because that's too onerous. That shuts down the content.
Ian Freeman was one of the Robinhooders at this hearing. He said,
"Okay, before I go into that, I want to comment on what the attorney was saying. That was the city's attorney saying, oh, well, we don't want to arrest them. That would be shutting down their free speech. No, that's such BS." And it was interesting because that line of questioning did not come up during the Superior Court hearing at all about,
right.
Well, why not arrest them? Well, he's making it sound like, well, we wouldn't have wanted to be seen as though we were against free speech. No, if we were out there actually assaulting these people, which is the suggestion that was being made by these
city
bureaucrats.
Right, and there were two instances that came up during the Superior Court mm-hmm. hearing, and both of them were incidental contact.
Even, in fact, in one of those instances, the parking enforcer admitted that she didn't think that the Robinhooder was trying to in any way manhandle her.
Actually, in both cases,
yeah.
Because the one... And it was to two different parking enforcers that it happened.
I couldn't remember the other one.
The one was where Jason Rapture tried to put a quarter in the meter, reaching around the parking enforcer because she was blocking the meter.
She was playing a little game.
And his hand, like, bumped her shoulder as he put the quarter in the meter.
She was trying to physically prevent him from doing that.
Yes.
Yeah.
And it was funny because he's not one of the six named defendants in the case. And she actually had to point him out and have him stand up in the audience.
That's right.
And the judge was like, he's not one of the defendants. So there's really only the one instance where one of the Robin Hooders that's named in the suit had contact. And that's the one where they were both reaching for a flyer up under the windshield and they touched hands.
So this attorney's acting like, oh, well, we didn't want to arrest them because, you know, yeah, we could have arrested them, but we didn't want to because, you know, that would be shutting down their free speech. Total BS. These guys will arrest you for filling out your driver's license form wrong. I just got through 6 months of trials and hearings, you know, various court hearings over some sort of piddly nonsense. If there's some piddly reason to arrest you, they will do it.
To be fair, it was a different government agency that arrested you.
They're all the state, man. They're all a monopoly on violence, and the city of Keene is not at all afraid to arrest activists for piddly nonsense.
I'm not saying that...
One of the Robin Hooders, Graham Coulson, who is no longer a Robin Hooder, but he was previously... He was arrested for walking through the park. They gave him an illegal no trespass order, banning him basically preemptively from going into Central Square, the main downtown park, and they arrested him for walking through the park. I mean, just if they have a reason to arrest an activist in Keene, they're going to do it. So this guy's just telling a lie in front of the Supreme Court.
Says their primary job is to feed expired meters before the attendants write tickets. Freeman says the claims of harassment are greatly overstated, but admits words are exchanged.
Every ticket that's left on somebody's windshield is a threat to steal that person's car, ultimately. So if I let that parking enforcer know how I feel about their job, they get offended by that because they don't want to feel like they're threatening people. They don't want to feel like they're doing a bad thing. I think they are.
So some people, Daryl, they will critique the kind of the terminology that some activists use to describe how government works. And I will describe, for instance, as I did there, the tickets as threats. You know, this is a threat.
Right.
If you don't do X, then we will do Y to you. And I see that as a threat. Do you think that's it's wrong? Do you think it's a bad approach to use words like that?
I don't think that it's necessarily wrong. But it is something that is going to wind up causing you to say a lot more words to explain what it is that you're trying to say, because not everybody's going to understand what you mean by a parking ticket is a threat.
Yeah. Well, I don't really care if everybody understands what I mean. I'm only trying
to... Right, but if you're trying to convey a message, then you want people, presumably, you want people to understand what you're trying to say.
Well, I figure that the people I'm trying to reach already understand what I'm trying to say, right? Like most people, I don't know, maybe it's not most people. I feel like most people who get parking tickets feel like they're under some sort of a threat, like because they know if they don't pay the ticket that eventually their car's going to get taken or it'll get a boot put on it or they're going to end up getting it towed or something like that, you know, one of those things.
Right, that they understand it in context. Mm-hmm. But when they just hear somebody say a parking ticket is a threat, it totally lacks context, and a lot of people aren't going to understand what you're saying.
The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, but how many is a lot? What percentage of people don't understand that a parking ticket is a threat? I wonder about that. Toll-free number here, 855-450-FREE. You can share your thoughts with us on this or anything that's on your mind. Free Talk Live.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
Talk radio generally, and Free Talk Live specifically, are a really inexpensive way to reach customers. All advertising is about return on investment. If you keep your investment low, you have a better chance of seeing a proper return. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations and the internet, reaching hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark at freetalklive.com.
Hi folks, Ronnie McMullen here for Life Change Tea. Healthcare is a problem, whether you're for or against Obamacare. It's a mess. My question is, who do you trust? Do you want to be told what to do, or do you want to make your own decision? My opinion, preventative maintenance. Keeping your colon clean is preventative maintenance. A little exercise, a balanced diet, and drinking Life Change Tea. It tastes great, and it helps with constipation, high cholesterol, liver problems, acid reflux, and much, much more. And with the holiday season upon us, you can get some extra tea for free. Don't wait for Obama. Make your own decision. Order now. Call us at 928-308-0408. That's 928-308-0408. Or you can log on to getthetea.com. That's getthetea, T-E-A,
Tea.com. Ridding yourself of harmful toxins is truly preventative maintenance. GetTheTea.com.
Free Talk Live, the show where anyone can call about whatever they want. And we do mean anyone.
It's happening every day. They sip some kind of chemicals through the floor.
Oh, so it's like gas.
It sounds crazy, but it's the truth.
I was under the impression they were coming into your house and like
and
holding
injecting
you down.
You.
Well, they can come in. Oh, yeah, I got remote controls right now. I can't find them. I listen to this preacher man. Every time I listen to him, they some kind of way they turns the station off.
Maybe it's just going off.
I mean, you'd be surprised.
They've got the remote, Mark.
How much power they have, and that's what they got. They got a lot of power.
I think you should go get some help.
I think you should talk to somebody who cares about you and ask them about psychological help. Somewhere, someone has had gas pumped into their room, but I just don't think it's happening with Mary because she's outspoken.
What does she speak out against? I should have asked her that.
I don't
know. Damn it.
You're done.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with a chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Dial in toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. The Keen Robin Hooding case continues to make headlines. It was actually shared, the story that was done by thefreethoughtproject.com. They did a story about the Robin Hooders just a few days before the actual hearing on Wednesday, I think. And Cop Block on their Facebook page posted a link to the Free Thought Project page. Now, the Free Thought Project on its own is a very popular website. In fact, I did a little bit of Googling on them, and I found out they were only founded back in 2013, but they're already one of the top 5,000 sites in the entire world.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. I mean, according to Alexa, I think it's in the 5,000 range. It was very, very high up there. So congrats to them. But CopBlock's incredibly popular on Facebook with over 1 million likes, and they reposted this story, and it went viral. It got shared out to, like, as of yesterday, I think 2.7 million views or something crazy like that, which for a liberty-oriented story like that is very, very good. So people are interested in this. People are fascinated by it. And a lot of people are, unfortunately, misinformed by it. And when you're being interviewed by the mainstream media, the thing you want to do is try to keep your answers as short as possible. And I understand what you were saying earlier, Daryl, about the answer I gave to the question that I was being asked by the media, where I referenced how it was that, you know, maybe these parking enforcers don't like being talked to and said, you know, having things said to them about how their job is immoral, like how I think that the tickets that they write are threats. You know, obviously, I don't have time to go into that and explain why a ticket is a threat, right? Because I'm trying to answer a question in a very short time frame.
Right.
And you never really know. You know, they asked me 6 questions or something like that, and only one of my answers made it into the actual clip at the
right.
end.
And even if you would have wound up giving an explanation, they're pushed for time, so they're only going to take a soundbite of it.
Yeah. It could have been cut. In fact, so, you know, you can only say so much, but at the same time, I wouldn't have just wanted to say that I think their job's immoral, because that gives no explanation of why I think that.
Right.
Right. At least if I add in, because they're threatening people, then at least I've explained my position. And I don't expect a bunch of people to all of a sudden be swayed based on a statement like that. It's just a news clip. Maybe they'll take the time to look up Robin Hood of Keene on Facebook or, you know, on the internet and, you know, actually do their own research and then come to their own conclusions. Or maybe somebody will hear that and say, yeah, it is a threat what they're doing. You know, I've gotten a ticket before. I know what that feeling was like. So I don't know. I don't know. You never know what people's responses are going to be. But one thing you can be certain of is that there will be a variety of them, that some people will not like what you're saying at all. Some people will love it and others will be confused.
Right. And that there's always going to be that percentage of people that either know a cop or they're related to a cop or they used to be a cop, that they will forever defend everything that police do. So if you do say they're threatening people and then explain, you know, like if they put a parking ticket on somebody's car, then if the person doesn't pay it, then they'll steal the car and this and that. The people will still find ways to justify that.
Absolutely.
Well, if the person would have just complied, if the person would have just always done everything that they were ever told, ever.
They own the roads, Daryl. I mean, they can put parking meters up. It's totally legitimate. You need to obey. There's all kinds of excuses for parking enforcement. And, you know, when you tell somebody that thinks the government owns the roads, that the government only owns the roads because they appropriated them usually through the threat of force, and they continue to fund them through the threat of force, that just goes over their head. It doesn't matter. That's just a non-issue for them because they accept the government as legitimate. They accept the force that the government uses on people as legitimate. And so, therefore, it's completely valid that they own the roads in the same way that to them, slaughtering the Indians would have been completely valid because it was the government that did it.
Right. And there's the question that always comes up of, well, you do realize that everywhere there's parking meters everywhere. Well, no, there's not parking meters everywhere.
There's plenty of towns that don't have them.
Yeah. I went and ate lunch with some people earlier today. Didn't have to put money in a parking meter because we went to a big giant shopping center where the shopping center owns the entire parking lot. The shopping center has it in their interest to provide parking for their customers.
Right, they managed to actually clear that lot of snow and garbage all throughout the year, and they do it all without charging any of the customers anything. You can go to that lot, park in that parking space, and never buy a thing in the stores that you go to. You just go and look at all the stuff in those stores and never buy anything, and you'll never have an issue with the ownership.
Right, because as far as they know, you're buying something. You're in the store. You're either buying something or you're comparing prices to buy something in the future.
Right. You may buy something at some point, and they're willing to allow you to park there on the hopes that you might.
And then the objection is, well, you're talking about a private parking lot versus government, blah, blah, blah. Well, okay, let's talk about municipalities that don't have parking meters. Newport, New Hampshire doesn't have parking meters.
Most of Laconia, New Hampshire doesn't.
Most of Laconia doesn't. Weirs Beach, which is one of the towns next to Laconia, has parking meters, but they're only enforced during the summertime.
Ah, okay. So, so there's all kinds of people who support the government on this stuff. And you can't convince everybody. You really can't. I always thought that Robin Hooding was one of the best forms of activism out there, that it was one of the most unassailable because you're helping people. You know, you're not just out there protesting. You know, when you go out there and you, like, a classic activism form is to go out and hold signs. We're angry about something and you need to stop doing this or whatever.
Well, and remember during the city council hearing, or it was actually a city council committee hearing about chalking. We need to make sure that chalk is considered graffiti. Everybody, or not everybody, but the vast majority of people that got up to say, chalk is the devil, we need to ban it, were people saying, you know, like, it's different when people just go hold a sign and then go home at the end of the day or after an hour. Like, we don't have to see them all the time holding the sign.
Right, because chalk is a different – it is true that chalk is a different way of communicating a temporary message, but ultimately it is still a temporary message. I don't think they did anything about that chalking ordinance, did they?
I don't think they did.
I have to admit, I don't –
because it was not long after they took that under advisement and instructed the city to write something up
that the Robin Williams Memorial came up where mm-hmm. people started chalking messages
That's
outside
right.
or on the sidewalk right by the parish shoe sign.
So I wonder what happens there, because they, in the case where they were talking about banning chalking in downtown Keene, they had requested that city staff come back with some sort of proposed ordinance, some sort of proposed writing to do that. Does that mean they can just not come back with it ever? Like, well, we're still working on it. I mean, it's been months now since that happened.
Who's to say that the city didn't give something to them and they decided we're not going to do anything with this?
But they would have had to have given it back. It would have had to have shown back up on one of the agendas for the city meetings.
Like, not necessarily.
No? You don't think so? You don't think they would have had to? If they were presenting it to the city council or whatever, it would have had to have gone public. That's what I'm saying. It seems like it's just been taken off the table as though that it never...
Or it could have been sent to the counselors as a private correspondence for the counselors to decide if they wanted to put it on the agenda.
Well, they could have
because
sent them...
Because I know whenever you or I or anybody else goes down to the city clerk with a correspondence to the city council, they ask the question, do you want us to make copies and put this in their box, mm-hmm. or do you want us to put this on the agenda?
Interesting. Yeah, I
so
can't say I know for sure.
You can make either a public or a private correspondence.
I can't say I know for sure how that system works with as far
I don't
as,
either.
Right.
But, you know.
All I know is I haven't seen anything.
But
and
presuming that correspondences from city officials are the same as correspondences from you or I.
I wouldn't presume they
are. It can be either public or private.
Yeah, I wouldn't presume they are. I mean, if they were asked publicly at a city meeting to come back with something and report back, that usually means they have to report back at some subsequent meeting.
That would be logical.
Well, okay, it's true.
But, you know, they always find ways to not comply with whatever when it's convenient for them to not comply.
Yeah, or maybe it's just one of those things where, you know, they were told to do that or asked to do that, and then they were asked maybe that as just a follow-up at one of the meetings, hey, have you come up with this? And nope, we haven't yet. We'll get back to you
right
when it's done. I don't know. And of course, it's also possible we missed it. I hope that we wouldn't, because
I don't think we have, because there's
activists.
Enough people that are reading those agendas.
Yeah, we've got some activists in town who are pretty good about reading through those agendas,
and
so we would have heard about that.
It was back in January when the city council had requested some kind of update to the parking stuff.
Was that January when they
and
were proposing
that
the increased?
Just came up 2 nights ago
when they were proposing the increased rates.
Yeah, that was back in like January, February.
Now, I didn't read the new proposal, but I heard it doesn't include increased rates.
I've not read it either, but that's the same thing that I heard.
All right, we'll come back with more next hour. All kinds of other news to discuss. We'll take it out to Facebook, where a court has decided parents may be liable for what their kids post there. We'll come back with more. You can share your thoughts as well. 855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number. We're coming up here on Free Talk Live. Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Nesquik. Try Nesquik 4-packs, perfect for lunches and great for kids on the go. Look for it in the juice aisle. Snack time is a great chance to sneak extra calcium into your child's diet without making him feel like he's eating something he doesn't want. Serve up dairy-rich foods like smoothies, flavored milk, frozen yogurt, and string cheese. He'll love the treat, and you'll love knowing how good it is for him. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308.
It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The Listen Lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, October 17th, 2014. Gold is trading around $1,240, silver around $17.36, and Bitcoin is trading around $383. Today's Bitcoin price brought to you by ExpressCoin, the fastest and most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. In the news, the United Nations High Commissioner for Human Rights has warned that extreme quarantine measures for Ebola patients could violate human rights and discourage reporting of the illness. Saeed Rayad Al Hussein said issuing criminal penalties for those who don't report is very likely to backfire by driving the epidemic underground. The statements came as President Obama issued an executive order that will allow the Pentagon to make use of reserve troops to tackle Ebola in Africa. There are no immediate plans to send the reservists or the National Guard to the continent, but the military maintains the option to do so. Researchers with the Multidisciplinary Association for Psychedelic Studies have raised nearly $142,000 for a study of MDMA-assisted psychotherapy for post-traumatic stress disorder in veterans. MAPS ran an Indiegogo crowdfunding campaign asking supporters to donate towards covering the cost of a new study in Boulder, Colorado. A recently published study found that 83% of those who experienced MDMA-assisted therapy were no longer diagnosed with PTSD and had significant improvements. MAPS is working to legalize MDMA research by 2021. A controversial national park in Tanzania has been the subject of protests by the Uvinji community. The small coastal fishing community is comprised of only 130 people, but their cause has received international attention after their land was included in a new map for a game reserve. The Tanzania National Parks Authority is attempting to drive the community out of the reserve, which now includes their land. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Marjorie Wildcraft's Grow Your Own Groceries. Homegrown food on every table. That's growyourowngroceries.org. Support also comes from Be the Media, a workshop, mini-conference, and party exploring alternative media and celebrating the launch of the Liberty Beat GCN partnership. It happens Saturday, October 25th, and will be live streamed at thelibertybeat.com. Be the media and change the world. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, October 16th, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. And make sure you like us on Facebook. That's facebook.com/thelibertybeat. 1 year in the House of Correction suspended on good behavior for 1 year and 100 hours of community service. That's the sentence handed down Thursday to the host of the nationally syndicated Free Talk Live radio program. Ian Freeman's sentence was decided by Keene, New Hampshire Superior Court Judge Edward Burke, arising from the charges of unsworn falsification and prohibition. The charges stem from an arrest in April of this year and were based on the state's claim that Freeman failed to file the proper paperwork in order to use the name Ian Freeman for his New Hampshire driver's license. Freeman's given birth name is Bernard. Freeman's show co-host of 12 years, Mark Edge, provided character testimony, telling the court that Freeman would not learn from being locked in a cage, and has, through Edge's influence, recently toned down his controversial civil disobedience activism. Freeman told the Liberty Beat he's thankful that he's not going to jail, and that a suspended 1-year jail sentence is a hefty price to pay for getting a name change. The state prosecutor had recommended a sentence of 60 days in jail. The Free Barrett Brown Organization is asking supporters of the jailed journalist to mail letters to the judge that will sentence him on November 24th. The organization is asking for sympathetic letters detailing Barrett's contributions to be mailed to Judge Lindsay. Barrett Brown has been behind bars for over 2 years, a portion of which was spent bound by a gag order. He was originally accused of sharing a hyperlink to stolen data, hiding laptops, and threatening a federal agent. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free. by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. Support also comes from Sovereign Living, a podcast, blog, and reality show about what it takes to live a voluntary and natural life. Check out the blog at sovereignliving.com and watch episode 1 of the soon-to-be-released reality show at sovereignliving.tv. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, October 17th, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting. Reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
It's the Onion Radio News. A crazy man announces plans to stand in a doorway and yell at cars. This is Doyle Redland reporting. Dennis Fife, an Alhambra, California crazy man, held a press conference today to announce his intention to stand in the doorway of the office building at 2600 Kenilworth Avenue and yell at cars all day.
At approximately 9:30 a.m. on the day in question, shortly after I finish lunging at dogs, I will proceed to the front steps of the Simmons building and yell loudly for 9 hours. The screaming will be broken by a 15-minute fit of rigid catatonia, most likely in the late afternoon.
Among the topics Fife plans to address during his 9-hour rant, the Ace of Diamonds, bookshelves, the man trying to kill him, plastic bags in trees, Trapper John M.D., and papers everywhere. Doyle Redland for The Onion Radio News, online at theonion.com.
This is The Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. Dial toll-free and bring up whatever's on your mind. 855-450-FREE. That's the number brought to you by ProXPN. It's 855-450-3733 with you tonight. It's Ian here.
And Daryl.
Oh, got some news. Doing sort of court-related news here tonight. We've talked about the Robin Hood case at the New Hampshire Supreme Court, the Houston subpoenas that had come out that were demanding ministers hand over copies of their sermons to the city in Houston. They've been backing down on that. And in other court-related news, here's one from the Wall Street Journal's law blog. Parents can be held liable for what their kids post on Facebook, according to a Georgia appellate court, in a decision that lawyers say mark a legal precedent on the issue of parental responsibility over their children's online activity. The Georgia Court of Appeals ruled that the parents of a seventh grade student may be negligent for failing to get their son to delete a fake Facebook profile that allegedly defamed a female classmate. The trouble started in 2011 when, with the help of another student, the boy constructed a Facebook profile pretending to be the girl. He used a fat face app to make her look obese and posted profane and sexually explicit comments on the page depicting her as racist and promiscuous, according to court documents. Now, this sounds like typical middle school boy activities. This doesn't sound very unusual. I went to middle school with boys who were like this. And
well, the difference is when we were in middle school, there wasn't Facebook to do stuff like this.
True, but you know, something like that could have been accomplished to some extent. Like, you could have drawn a picture of someone as a fat face, put their name under it, and posted it up on a school poster board or something like that.
Right. The activity of, you know, like making fun of another student. Typical middle school sort of bully stuff.
That doesn't make it okay, but it's it's typical. But at the same time, it shouldn't be a crime, and nor should parents be responsible for it.
Well, technically, and I agree that it shouldn't be a crime, but the wording of the Computer Fraud Abuse Act and also the Facebook Terms of Service make it against the Facebook Terms of Service.
Really?
And against federal law to pretend to be somebody else online.
Really?
That's unless you're law enforcement, and then it's okay.
Is it against federal law to pretend? I'm not asking you because you're an attorney and you are no legal advice, but your opinion. What do you think? Is it against federal law to pretend to be someone who does not exist? Can you create a fake person?
Or it depends on for what purposes. So if it's, you know, a fake person that is being presented as a fictitious entity, then that would be allowed. And it depends, based on my understanding of, you know, what limited knowledge I have of the CFAA, then it could be illegal to create a fake persona if it could somehow be construed that it was for fraudulent purposes.
That's interesting. I did not realize that that was the case. Well, let's go on with this story here. The girl found out about the profile. She told her parents, who then complained to the school's principal. The school punished the boy with 2 days of in-school suspension and alerted his parents, who grounded him for a week. But for the next 11 months, according to the appeals court opinion, the page stayed up. It wasn't deleted until Facebook deactivated the account at the urging of the girl's parents, said the opinion. The girl's lawyer says the child's parents didn't immediately confront the boy's parents because their school refused to identify the culprit for confidentiality reasons. Given that the false and offensive statements remained on display and continued to... Well, wait a minute. Hold on. How did the school find out who was behind this?
Well, if he was using a school computer to do it...
Okay.
Then it's fairly easy to figure out who was using what computer on what day and...
Yeah, okay, good point. They could have, I suppose, reached out to
Facebook.
Or
even if it was one of these things of, it's a school provided, here's your free laptop.
Uh-huh, yeah, and they might have a log of where they went. Okay, yeah, maybe that's how they figured out. Because it would seem like just normally, if they'd gone and done this from their own home computers or whatever, then you know there wouldn't necessarily be a trail on that, unless Facebook informed the school. I guess what they could do is...
IP... request.
So they could have sent a request to Facebook, and you know it's probably the school resource officer, and I'm sure Facebook will fulfill requests without warrants. So I mean, I'm not sure of that, but they probably will. There's plenty of companies that will obediently do whatever the police ask them to do. So my guess would be that the school resource officer sent a letter to Facebook saying, we would like to know who the creator is of this page, because every right. page has a creator attached to it, and then they could have identified the creator, which was one or two of the boys in question, which would have allowed the school to know who the culprits were, but not the parents. Anyway, going on here, given this from the judge in the case, quote, given that the false and offensive statements remained on display and continued to reach readers for an additional 11 months, we conclude that the jury could find that the parents' negligence proximately caused some part of the injury that the girl sustained from the boy's actions and inactions, unquote, wrote Judge John J. Ellington in the opinion, which was handed down October 10th. He was joined by two other judges on that panel. The appeals court, though, agreed with the trial court's dismissal of another part of the lawsuit that sought to hold the parents responsible for allowing the page to be posted in the first place. Atlanta litigator, so that's good news. So they agreed with the dismissal of that portion of the lawsuit so that the parents couldn't have known how could they have been responsible for right. what their son did in this case. But to suggest that the parents would be negligent, it didn't sound like they were under orders to remove the page. The school punished the boy with in-school suspension and told his parents they grounded him for a week. They probably didn't even think to tell him to take the page down. You know, not all parents are aware of Facebook and, you know, how it works.
Right.
How could a parent be responsible to know all of the ins and outs of the technical things that their sons or daughters are doing on the internet? And in a lot of cases, your kids are far more internet, you know, I guess, able, internet apt than
right,
you would
right.
be as a parent. So I hope this doesn't go anywhere, but it's kind of a scary decision that they may be held negligent.
And even if
case.
They would have told the kid, you know, take that off of Facebook, if they're not, you know, super knowledgeable about how computers and internet and whatnot work,
yeah.
he could just close the window and say,
it's
there
gone.
It is. It's gone.
Or make another fake page and then delete that one and then just act as though you've already deleted the page.
Well, I'm sure if there was a second page made, it would have mentioned in the article that...
No, but what I mean is if he knew that the parents wanted him to delete the page, he could make another page and then show them, all right, mom, look, I'm going to delete
the
page.
Oh, right, right. Okay.
And then,
I see
like,
what you're
in
saying.
Front of her, delete the second fake page that he made.
Right, right.
And still have the original on there. So there's plenty of ways to dupe parents that aren't really, you know, keyed in with how the whole internet thing works. The appeals court, Atlanta litigator Edgar Magnifaco Jr., who defended the boy's parents, told LawBlog that the court's decision was marred by inconsistencies, said he would be appealing to the Georgia Supreme Court. He said that when he was researching the question of parental liability with respect to cyberbullying, he could not find any case in which a court found parents negligent for failing to supervise their kids' computer use. Natalie Woodward, an Atlanta attorney who represented the girl, said she also believed the outcome was a novel one. The ruling shows, she told LawBlog, that in certain circumstances, when what is being said about a child is untrue and once the parents know about it, then liability is triggered. I think that's a terrible idea. I hope this gets overturned at the Georgia Supreme Court. Look, I don't support cyberbullying or whatever you want to call it, making fun of people online or in real life. I don't support that. But on the other hand, I support free speech. And part of free speech is to allow people to say things that they don't, that you might not like. And I think part of free speech should also be to, you know, to be able to create fake Facebook profiles. Now, it's one thing to act as though one is another person and commit fraud on somebody. But to just create a Facebook profile for the point of making fun of somebody, I don't really see that as being fraudulent. I don't see that as, you know, it's a Facebook profile.
It could be fraudulent, but again, it definitely, you know, whether it's against a state or a local or a federal law or not, it is still against Facebook's terms of services to make a profile for someone that is not yourself.
Fair enough. Toll-free number 855-450-FREE, and that's their private property. They can decide right. whatever their terms and services are. And in that case, the remedy should be that Facebook bans that page and maybe bans the user if necessary.
Right.
You know, and case closed. More coming up here in moments. 855-450-FREE. Have you ever been cyberbullied or a cyberbully? It's Free Talk Live. Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com. Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
I am a non-attorney spokesperson. Attention men who've taken Androgel or any other testosterone therapy products. Androgel or other low-T products have been linked to heart attack, stroke, pulmonary embolism, deep vein thrombosis, even death. Scientific studies indicate that the use of testosterone therapy products may double a man's risk of heart attack. If you or a loved one took Androgel or a testosterone therapy product and suffered from a heart attack, stroke, pulmonary embolism, deep vein thrombosis, or any other cardiac event, you might be entitled to financial compensation. You have rights, and you need to let us fight for your rights. And you pay no fees unless we win. So call the Tort Attorneys right now. 800-708-7917. 800-708-7917. 800-708-7917. 800-708-7917. Cases may be referred to participating law firms in your jurisdiction.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything right here, toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's the number brought to you by ProXPN. It's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Go to freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that we share with you there. Again, freetalklive.com. At Free Talk Live, we love Bitcoin. In fact, if you've got Bitcoin, you can throw some in the Bitcoin tip jar over at bitcoin.freetalklive.com. But if you would also like to earn some Bitcoin, you can do that through BitcoinBountyHunter.com. There are bounties available right now. One of them is a 38 Bitcoin bounty. If you've got the skills to investigate this case, you could collect the bounty. You can even place your own bounties or even add to the ones that are already there. The authorities aren't going to be solving these cases. That'll be done by people like you who can profit from your work and skill. Go to BitcoinBountyHunter.com. Again, that's BitcoinBountyHunter.com. Before we get to your phone calls, Daryl, you wanted to add a little bit about the whole online bullying thing?
Right. And I had said that under the Computer Fraud and Abuse Act, it is technically illegal to post false information online through some sort of website for the purposes of fraud. And under a broad interpretation, I would be correct. However, there is a court that actually has some sense.
Okay.
And in this case, it's the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals that they heard a case a couple of years ago.
That's California, right? Ninth Circuit.
California, Oregon, right. Washington, and I believe Nevada.
Okay.
So, it's out there on the West Coast. They heard a case. It was the case of United States v. Drew, where a mother who had cyberbullied one of her daughter's classmates by posing as a 16-year-old boy was charged under the CFAA, and the court ruled that a broad interpretation of the CFAA could, quote, turn millions of unsuspecting individuals into perpetrators of computer crime. So under a broad interpretation, yes, making a fake Facebook profile is technically illegal.
Of another person or a person who does not exist?
Well, in this case,
this was of a real person.
It was of another person.
Right. So that they basically said that was okay in this case.
They said that it didn't violate the federal law.
Gotcha.
Doesn't say anything about whether it violates local law in California.
There are other cyberbullying laws that are
right
in the books
but,
in different places.
It did not violate the federal law because, it could if it was interpreted broadly, but this court decided on a narrow interpretation, and so therefore, based on current court precedent, you're not going to a federal prison for making a fake Facebook profile.
Look, I'm in favor of people trying to stop others from bullying. I was bullied as a kid, and I did some bullying as a kid. That's sort of the cycle of violence. So I definitely am guilty of it and have had it happen to me. I don't think it's a cool thing to do, and I regret doing that, and I tried to make good in high school to some of the people that I did make good to some of the people that I had picked on when I was younger. But ultimately, going to prison or going to jail or having my parents go to jail would not have helped that situation
right
in any way, shape, or form. And I don't think it would ever solve the problem of bullying. It's just it's a problem of young people being in a place together where they are being forced to be, ultimately. Like, you know, if you were sending your kids to a school and they were getting bullied there, and you, you know, were in a free market of education, you could then remove them from that school. If the school wasn't doing anything about it, or if the school wasn't doing enough to put a stop to it, you could say, well, I'm not going to be sending my child to your school next year, or, you know, now. Right. I'm pulling them out now. But at the government schools, you can't really do that because you're always forced to pay for the government school system. Even if you do pull your kids out of it,
right,
you're still ultimately paying for this environment where bullying, that's where it really comes from in a lot of ways. Now, look, I'm not saying that it wouldn't happen in a neighborhood group of kids. You know, that could happen too.
Right.
Anytime you get kids together, there's a chance some of them aren't going to get along and they're going to pick on one another. But at least in the neighborhood group example, your child doesn't have to hang out with those kids anymore. So let's continue with your calls and thoughts. We go to Cameroon, Africa. Akko is on the line with us here tonight. Were you calling from Bamenda tonight?
No, I'm not calling from Bamenda. I'm calling from Bambui, just some few miles from Bamenda.
Welcome back to the show, Akko. How are you tonight?
I'm doing fine. Excellent. Nice to be back on the show.
It is past, 2 a.m. there in Cameroon?
2:25 a.m. Yes, right here.
Staying up late listening to Free Talk Live over the free-to-air satellite where it is available across a lot of Africa, central sort of east-west Africa. So what did you want to share with our audience tonight, Akko?
Oh, I came here to discuss about something that is disturbing me, something about this government that we have here, which is corruption and police brutality and police taking money from drivers.
Hmm. Tell me more.
Yeah, for the past week, we have been witnessing some unprecedented level of corruption here. Many people and thousands of people have been complaining until they took to streets, protesting, writing placards. You cannot go into the office and certify your documents. You cannot go into any public office and get services. You must pay for the services. So Cameroonians are becoming weary and tired. So they want to voice out their grievances. And I think that it's better for me to take it at an international level.
So what you're saying is there are people in Cameroon who are protesting the awful conditions of the government offices where it's very difficult to deal with these government bureaucrats. Is that what I understood you to say?
Yeah, that is what I'm trying to say. Okay, for example, on Wednesday, one mother whose son is schooling in the University of Yaoundé took her son's birth certificate to have local administrators called senior divisional officers. She took it to that office to certify it and send it to her son because he has to do his university registration. The DO was asking her for 10,000 francs, which is equivalent to about $20. So the woman came back and alerted the whole community, and we decided to take this matter to the street. Because
so hold on. Wait. This lady wanted to get a birth certificate certified, and what was it that she was upset about?
And said it to her son, who is in the university, because he has to use it for registration. But the DO, the administrator was asking for 20,000 francs in order to do it. Look, this is what has been happening.
And you're saying that's too much? You're saying that he was trying to gouge her?
Under normal circumstances, the woman does not have to pay for any services because the guy there is representing the local community. He has to save the people.
I see.
You suck money from the people.
So the expectation is that because he's a government so-called servant, and they use these terms over here in the United States, they call themselves public servants.
Yes.
Because he's a servant, that should be done for free. Now, in the United States, these government agents are charging fees all over the place. I mean, almost everything they do, there's a fee attached to it. Has it been the case that this birth certificate certification has been free in the past, and now all of a sudden this administrator wants to pocket $20?
When they feel that you can alert the anti-corruption committee here, when they feel that you can alert them, then they will not charge you anything. But when they think that you are ignorant, you don't know you're right, they will charge
They'll
you
charge
money.
You. All right, stand by. Akko, hang on. We'll bring you back for more of this in moments. It's Free Talk Live.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin? Any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too. Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. We'll take your calls and you can dial in about anything that you want. Talking about corruption in Cameroon, Africa with Akko, who is on Skype. We're going to get right back into him just a moment, but I also want to let you know how to get some great coffee. It's from BuzzBox and it's a free pound of the best coffee out there. 100% organic and top 1% grade Arabica. Shade grown as well. Coffee from BuzzBox is awesome coffee. At least that's what I'm told by professional coffee drinkers like Mark Edge, our regular weeknight co-host. He downs at least a pot of BuzzBox on a daily basis.
Decaf. He does the decaf.
He does.
Because Mark can't handle caffeine.
Ooh. And BuzzBox, by the way, is competitively priced with other high-end coffees, but they do something else that really makes them outstanding. And that is that there's a program that we're working with BuzzBox and Kiva.org to help change people's lives by offering people in poverty an opportunity to change their own lives through microloans from Kiva. Now, the way this works is for every 10 Free Talk Live listeners who signs up for the autoship program at coffee.freetalklive.com, for every 10, we can fund a new microloan. And every time that microloan gets paid off, we'll refund to a different microloan.
What if one person has 10 different personalities and 10 different orders? Does that count as 10 people?
As long as we don't know that it's, you know, as if it's 10 different orders, if you're shipping 10 pounds of coffee per month, then yeah, that would qualify for another microloan.
Okay.
Yeah. So coffee.freetalklive.com. Again, go there and get your free pound. Just pay the shipping cost. You can cancel your subscription at any time. Coffee.freetalklive.com. We go back to Cameroon, Africa, where Akko is on the line. And Akko, thanks for hanging on here. You were explaining some of the corruption there in Africa, which, of course, corruption's everywhere in governments all around the world. And so it's interesting to hear how it works in other parts of the world, and that's what you're explaining to us right now. You were talking about a lady who was trying to get a birth certificate certified so her son could go off to college. And you say that the people who know their rights, these government bureaucrats will not charge them anything. But if the government bureaucrat thinks they can pull the wool over your eyes, they can fool you, that you don't know your rights, then they'll demand a fee for one of these services, which you say is supposed to be free. So this guy was demanding $20. Now, $20 is a lot of money in Cameroon, Africa, because you told me in the last phone call you made a couple weeks ago that, or maybe like a week or so ago, you told me, Akko, that the average pay is less than a U.S. dollar per day there in Cameroon. Is that true?
Absolutely. More than 95% of Cameroonians live below $1 per day. So you can imagine what $20 will mean to that old lady.
That's like a month's worth of pay.
Who cannot have service at her disposal, which is put there to save the people, the masses, the poor, the rich, I mean the public, but they want to extort money from the people. I mean, it is no secret that in Cameroon, ever since President Paul Biya has taken power in 1982, Cameroon has rapidly degenerated into a state of chaos, into an economy dominated by a seat of bribe and extortion by the administrators. And that is what is killing us. Not that we are inherently a poor country, as I earlier said during the last time when I was on the show. It is our government officials who have decided to put us at this particular level for more than 30 years.
Absolutely. Now, you also wanted to comment on the police and them stopping people on the roads there?
Yes. As I was traveling from Dob to Bambui, which is just about 35 kilometers, we had about 7 police check points where the police are supposed to check whether people are walking with their ID card and the appropriate papers.
How many checkpoints?
As well as the drivers. About 7 of them.
7 checkpoints. And how long was the drive?
Just 35 kilometers.
Wow.
We haven't even gotten to Bamenda, which is 40 kilometers from them. About 7 of them. I mean, in Cameroon, you just find police officers running away from their offices and standing on the roadside where they will take money from the drivers. Because if they realize that the drivers do not have the appropriate papers, maybe they have not insured their vehicles, or maybe they don't have the first aid box, they will just charge the drivers and take some money from them. So just imagine such a country where the police do not save the people, but rather their own self-aggrandizement.
I couldn't make out what you said. Can you come back on that?
Yeah, I'm saying that the police in Cameroon, they do not stay in their offices to save the people, to fight against crime and security. They are on the roadside taking money from the drivers.
Well, that's pretty much what happens in all the countries around the world. You know, that's basically what they do here. Now, when you're at one of these checkpoints, you're giving them the cash right there and then, though, right?
Yeah, the driver will, at each checkpoint, the driver is entitled to giving about $1 to $2.
Wow.
If you don't give it, they will take you and jail you. But if you give it, even if you are carrying contrabands or narcotics in your vehicle, it doesn't matter. You just have to go.
So the drug dealers can easily cover these costs because they make all kinds of money on the drugs that they're selling.
Ian, I assure you, if you have money, you can transport cocaine, marijuana, or whatever drug or whatever thing that you can transport, as far as whenever you go to a checkpoint,
I believe
you give $1 or $2 to policemen, you just make your way.
Is that about what it would cost to get into the country too? Like if I were coming from one of the bordering nations there to Cameroon, and I wanted to, you know, cross the border over over there. Let's say I was coming from Nigeria, for instance. I wanted to cross into Cameroon. Would it be a buck or two?
You don't even need to make papers from Nigeria in order to come to Cameroon. You just have to get to the border and give them $2 or $3. Then you just make your way into Cameroon.
That's amazing. So it's just, you know, it's really just a scale though, right? Like, so what you're experiencing in Cameroon is just, it's on a scale of oppression. It's just different. Like, in fact, some would say that it's more preferable.
It's more okay, obvious.
Right.
Ian, the problem that we are suffering here in Cameroon is one. Imagine a president who is 84 years old, a president who is tired, a president who is an ailing person, a president who is always hospitalized, a president who knows nothing about the actualities of the world, who knows nothing about our economy, who knows nothing about our educational system, but the president is there with all ministers who have been rotating from one ministry to the other for 32 years. So just imagine. And the youth of Cameroon have never been a priority for this government. So what good thing can ever come from such a government?
I think nothing doubt. It's definitely a corrupt place. There's no doubt about it. And the fact that they are staying in power so long, it prolongs the corruption. It deepens the corruption. I mean, there's no doubt about that. And I want to thank you, Akko, by the way. And just real quick to add in here,
Ian, I have a point to make.
Go ahead, quickly.
Yeah, I have a point to make. Mm-hmm. We are a developing nation of which the government is targeting us to be an emerging economy in 2035. But they do not know that our economy, for our economy to grow and create jobs, it has to be linked to technology and telecommunication.
Well, plus you can't grow.
Cameroonians,
you can't grow the economy if people are having a day's worth of their pay stolen from them just to try to drive into town. I mean, that's going to hurt the economy terribly.
Imagine before you have access to the internet, you have to move from rural areas to urban areas just for you to be connected and maybe to carry out your transaction. But meanwhile, if we were connected and technology was everywhere, our economy would boom because people will create, it will bring about jobs and many other opportunities.
Sure.
But our government, which is filled with aging and old people who do not know anything about technology, they're sitting.
Well, one thing they know something about is how to extract as much money as possible from the people there and keep them poor, because that's really what stops jobs from being created. And Akko, thank you for the call tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you. That's what stops jobs from being created. Yeah. It's not necessarily that technology is, or the lack of technology. It's that you can't start a business in a place where there's oppression.
Right. And what he was saying about the police being on the side of the roads, I've heard that it's like that in a lot of the Central American countries, to where the cops will be on the side of the road flagging people down saying, we need gas money.
We'll come back with more here in moments. 855-450-FREE, and we'll talk a little bit more about some of the differences between governments. Free Talk Live.
Hey guys, if you're into fantasy football, you've got to check out FanDuel.com. At FanDuel, you play in one-week fantasy football leagues for real money with immediate cash payouts. You only play when you want, and you can change your team any week. FanDuel is paying out over $10 million every week this season. And right now, FanDuel is giving you up to $200 free. That's right, for every dollar you deposit, FanDuel will match it up to $200. Just go to FanDuel.com, click the microphone in the upper right corner, and enter code FOOTBALL70. FANDUEL.com, code FOOTBALL, the number 70.
Khalid lives in Gaza. He makes his living as a taxi driver. The engine in his old beater blew up. Now, he makes good money driving people in his cab, but he couldn't afford the $1,300 for a new engine. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the engine, and he's back on the road. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time.
Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com.
With autumn in the air, it's time to think about getting ready for winter. And it's time to save at herbalhealer.com. You'll find amazing seasonal savings to prepare you for the fight against cold and flu season. Like oregacillin to promote lung health. 30 capsules, regularly $34.95, now only $25. HHA olive leaf, the natural antiviral, normally $16.95, now 60 capsules are just $12. HHA elderberry power, a great flu and virus fighter, regularly $16.95, 60 capsules, now $10. Save on all our homeopathic detoxes. Choose from lungs, kidney, liver, brain, libido, or whole body, normally $26.95, now just $20. Visit herbalhealer.com and click on the fall winter specials button to save on all our natural cold and flu fighting products. Also, explore our Herbal Healer Academy correspondence courses that teach you how to handle your health naturally. HerbalHealer.com, healing the world with nature, one person at a time, since 1988.
Keenvention is coming up October 31st through November 2nd. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, attend social events like the costume party. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, James Robin Hood Cleveland, Rich Paul, and Free State Project President Carla Garrick will be keynoting. And we'll have all kinds of panels, including the new Cop Block panel and the new Movers panel hosted by the outlaw Josie Wales. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of governments around the world killing innocent people? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin is money that cannot be inflated or controlled by any state. By continuing to use their money, you're perpetuating the killing. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available to you now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. It's weusecoins.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Dial in toll free here, 855-450-FREE, or join us on Skype, as Akko did from Cameroon, Africa. And it sounded good for most of his call. Kind of connection went a little bad towards the end, but considering he's calling from an internet connection that is pretty unreliable, I thought it was sounding pretty good, all things considered. So you can join us on Skype. Our username there is lrn.fm. And uncovering the secrets and exposing the lies, that's what the readers of freedomsphoenix.com get every day. Readers of freedomsphoenix.com are constantly provided the detailed real news that lies between the lines of propaganda and the relationship we have with coercive governments. freedomsphoenix.com offers up-to-the-minute updates on the economy, technology, communications, and the rise of the police state. Go now to freedomsphoenix.com and sign up for their free daily dispatch. That's freedomsphoenix.com. By the way, I wanted, before we go on with a few more calls, there were, or the next caller, I wanted to comment a little further about Akko. We had him on like a week ago.
Yeah.
And there was, toward the end of the show, we had talked about how, you know, maybe getting him a little bit of money because it costs him, as he was just talking about, just, you know, going 30 kilometers. They had 7 checkpoints where the police are extracting a buck
right
or two from everybody going through. And, you know, it doesn't sound like a lot of money to us, but to them, a dollar is a day's worth of pay.
Right. So that would sort of be the equivalent of getting stopped 7 times and each time being stopped, the cop saying, give me $100 and I'll let you go.
Yeah. So that's pretty crazy. And I, you know, I appreciate Akko spending the time and the effort to, because he can't get on online where he lives and his where his home is in Indop, there in the Bamenda region of Cameroon. And so he has to travel to the city, basically, to get online. And it costs money to travel, and it costs money to get internet access. And so the idea was, well, let's take up a little collection. And, you know, you and I, Daryl, kicked in $20 a piece. And,
right.
And then online listeners on the Free Talk Live Amplifier forum kicked in some more money. And we easily raised $100 to send to him that night. And then, you know, I posted, that was like literally 2 hours after we ended the show. So within 2 hours, we raised $100. I sent it to him via MoneyGram. And also I had Akko create a Bitcoin wallet. And so he gave me the Bitcoin address and I collected Bitcoin contributions for him as well. So he's got about $45 worth of Bitcoin right now. We sent him $100 worth of cash via MoneyGram. And then later contributions came in. I basically totaled up everything that came in over the weekend. Anytime someone sent a PayPal indicating that it was for Akko,
right.
I totaled all that up. And then, so we had another $135 that we could send to him. And just after I sent him the $100, he was so appreciative, saying that that I made him cry, that no one has ever given him such a huge sum of money. He intends to use part of the money to connect with others who want to be connected with LRN.FM by listening via satellite. That's really the only way to listen out there. You can't really get online, and if you do get online, you're paying for bandwidth, and so,
right.
You know, why not just get the satellite where it's free to air? The total amount that the $100 translates into 51,000 francs. So, you know, it sounds like a good chunk of money out that way. And so to send him another $135 was just like an amazing, this has been just an amazing experience. And for him, generosity, having never been given anything like that in his entire lifetime. So I just want to thank everybody who pitched into that. That was really cool. So thank you for that. Our toll-free number here tonight, 855-450-FREE. Just a couple things that I wanted to add to what Akko was saying there about, you know, in Cameroon, you get stopped on the road, you pay off the police, they leave you alone. If you don't pay them off, they arrest you. The payoff is a buck or two, and that's like $1, like a day's worth of pay in Cameroon, Africa. So that's an expensive tax to try to get to where you're going.
Right, but it's not that different if you think about it. It's just a little more obvious,
right,
what they're doing there. Here, you get stopped for some kind of infraction. Oh, you were going a mile and a half over the speed limit. You have to now go to court and
yes.
Give us money.
That's what I wanted to explain to Akko, but he had a lot that he wanted to get off his chest. So the other thing I wanted to add was that it's just a scale of difference. It's just, you know, the United States isn't a more free place than Cameroon in that way. We still have police stopping us on the streets, maybe not as often, but, you know, the police will stop us on the streets and they'll issue you a ticket, which comes with an envelope, and you can put the money into the envelope and then send that off to some central processing bureaucracy where it is then processed into the state's coffers.
The corruption in the U.S. is written into statute to where it doesn't look like corruption.
Yes.
Because, well, we've got it written down that we're allowed to do this.
It's more obscured from view. And that's why I would say from our perspective, it almost seems like, you know, as wealthy Westerners in comparison, it almost seems like, oh, I'd rather just give a guy a buck or two and make him go away than
right.
have to deal with court and have to deal with a $50 or $400 guy. James Cleveland here in Keene got a $400 speeding ticket in Massachusetts recently.
Yeah.
I mean, so that's ridiculous. That's, you know, a lot of pay for the average person. And so again, the difference is only in degrees between here and a place like Cameroon or North Korea or
and
whatever.
The guise of legitimacy that's behind it.
That's right. The American government's brilliance is that they are very successful at having that guise of legitimacy or the aura of legitimacy. And the other thing that I thought was important to point out is that, yes, it's certainly true that having technology helps with creating new jobs and business, which is what Akko was saying at the end of his call. But what helps more than anything, because, you know, jobs were created before technology, you know, internet and things
right.
like that. What is the most important thing is to not have a government extracting wealth constantly from people,
right.
Demanding a dollar just to drive from point A to point B, or demanding $7 or whatever just to drive from point A to point B, when that's taking away a week's worth of your pay.
in Cameroon, that's a huge detriment to the ability to create savings, to save up enough money to open up a business, to start a business in your home or rent a storefront or something like that. It makes it impossible to do that. But even if you were able to save enough money to start your own business in a place like Cameroon, then there are likely going to be payoffs you'll have to make in order to start the business.
Right.
You'll have to pay the government bureaucrats to allow you to start the business. Now, in the United States, they call that licensing. They call that, you know, approval. They have to have some inspector come out. And that's the same thing as a government thug coming around.
A zoning variance.
Right. And that's the same thing as a government thug with a club saying, give me your money and I'll let you do business. So it's the same thing here in the United States. In most places, you also have to beg permission to start a business. But, you know, if you can't save the money to the first point to where you could even pay off the bureaucrats to start a business, that's a huge impediment to being able to create wealth for yourself and to create jobs for other people.
And then with the tickets, at least you can then, you know, take it to court and possibly wind up winning. I had a friend out in Mississippi who actually told me that she was able to get a ticket dismissed. She wound up having to go three different times. The first time she showed up was the arraignment, where you just say guilty or not guilty, and then they tell you, come back on this other day. She went back the next day, and there was a sign posted, court has been canceled today, come back on this other day. So she went back, and because they wrote her name down wrong, they thought that she was supposed to have been on another day, and they were like, you weren't here 2 days ago. We were about ready to file a warrant, and she was like, did you have my name this way? And they're like, no, we had it with the another letter as the first letter of the last name. So she got that straightened out and wound up having a court hearing. I think it was Tuesday of this week. Was told, be here at 1:30. Gets there at 1:30, and she sees a note that says, ask about taking a driving class to have your ticket go away. So when the judge called her up, he said, yeah, there was something about taking a driving class. He said, if you want to do the driving class, you still have to pay the fine. She said, then I'll plead not guilty.
Yeah, why bother?
Prosecutor said, smart move, because the trooper said he had better things to do.
Nice.
He's not showing up. We have to dismiss it.
Yeah, you don't ever have any options until you go with not guilty. Let's go to Alma in Tallahassee. You're on Free Talk Live. Alma.
Hey, sweetie.
What's on your mind tonight?
Quick comments, if you'll let me, before I tell you what I called about.
Well, you don't really have time for a bunch of comments, so maybe pick one.
Oh, my goodness. Facebook is evil, and it's hell to get a birth certificate here in the United States if you don't have an ID. But I have my tinfoil hat on.
Oh, boy.
And I feel like I am being jerked around with Ebola. Five people in different places. They said they're going to put them in one place. I think Agenda 21's coming in, which is really Agenda 22, if you'll read it.
Honestly, I don't read government writings like that. I've really got better things to do with my time. But there's no doubt that...
read it, darling.
There's no, I'm not going to do it. There's no doubt in my mind that there are people who want to control me, right? Like, I know that there are people around the world who...
what's going on now.
Yeah.
It's Agenda 21.
Agenda
22. If you'll look at it,
or 21. Or whatever.
Yeah, it's 22, if you'll read it. They left out the last
one. What about the other 20?
All right, I got it all outlined. I can tell you all of it.
What about Agenda 23?
It took me hours and hours and hours, 6 hours to read it.
I wish I could talk to you further about it, Alma, but we're out of time for tonight. But call another night, and we'll be happy to hear more about these scary agendas, which, you know, I don't doubt there are people out there who want to control us. I just I don't really care about what all their plans are. I'm just going to try to be as free as I can. More coming up tomorrow.
And if you thought things couldn't get more infantile and aesthetically insulting than Fergie, Kesha, or Katy Perry, then you obviously haven't met 22-year-old Karanika, the latest and most horrid talent-bereft pop monstrosity the music industry has ever sadistically forced down the American public's collective throat. She's here with us in the studio right now.
What?
Now tell us, Karanika, how did you first decide that you wanted to be the cipher through which the cynicism of a morally bankrupt industry is channeled?
Yo, I just do what I do. Know what I'm saying? It's like... people just love my ish.
Right. You are in the middle of your sold-out Damn Girl tour.
Damn Girl! That's right!
Which is a heinous slap in the face to the English language, and will also travel to 47 cities, sapping the intellects of every young person along the way.
I said Damn Girl! That's right!
There's no light in your eyes, Karanika.
I got nothing to say to the haters. I hate you.
This is the Onion News Network.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
The Corey Moore Show is coming up next, live after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, October 17th, 2014. Silver is trading at $17.38 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,240 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $385. Antiwar.com reports, a month into the Islamic State push against the Kurdish border town of Kobani, the Kurdish forces in the city are continuing to hold it and have even made some progress. Commanders of Kurdish forces say they've driven out the Islamic State from parts of the town, and they believe they can take back the pockets of resistance of the Islamic State fighters elsewhere. Exactly what's going on the ground remains unclear, as Kurdish factions are keen to manage the narrative. People across the border in Turkey, however, report considerable fighting is still visibly going on in the city. Though, when the battle for Kobani was going poorly, the U.S. insisted that it was not a priority. The Obama administration has launched scores of airstrikes in and around Kobani, and if the Kurds manage to expel the Islamic State, even temporarily, expect U.S. officials to change their tune and tout it as a vindication of their war strategy. The Islamic State has tried to take Kobani several times, unsuccessfully, and has significant reinforcements incoming. Needless to say, the battle for the town remains far from resolved. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They now take Bitcoin for purchasing precious metals so you can turn your profits into a long-term investment.